welcome to TDA Today After, your favourite news platform and the home of popular culture as defined by the actual culture. And of course, we are hosted by the absolute best. Please, everyone, introduce yourselves.
Oh, is it me today?
Yeah, you can do it today. We'll let you.
You're so dramatic. That was one time.
One time. One time. Go ahead. Go ahead, princess.
No, honestly.
I am cold, by the way.
We can tell.
I turned the aircon off, so hopefully it'll be warm in a second.
You are very dramatic, you know.
He's so
he's acting out what we can obviously see.
He's just like, I don't know, like your kiddies can, they can read your temperature, babe. They're fine.
It's me, Big Marshall, east side of the bridge. You know what time it is already.
Nice day
for it.
Nice day what?
I said it's a nice day for it.
For what?
You kind of covered
up. Just to win.
Kind of covered up. I like you in shorts, you know. Mash town chain and everything.
Yeah, because you know it's really hot today. Did you look at the weather today, babes?
I wasn't wearing this.
It's like a 20.
Yeah, but this tracksuit is light though. This one.
But what are you wearing, Mugs?
I'm saying I was wearing this. I ain't got a hoodie on, I think. I'm fine.
Okay.
You want to see my, you want to see the chest?
No, no, it's all right.
Yeah,
I've
chest
seen
and everything.
I've seen it. But for the views, go on. Just do something
take
nasty.
Take the top. Show me a cleavage.
No.
You know, if you said that the other way around, the show would be cancelled.
Nah, Brent wouldn't put it out.
Yeah, Brent couldn't put it out on the street. No way, that's crazy.
Pull me to the side, make sure I'm okay. But it's the undramatic. Nah, you know, I shouldn't have done that.
You're very dramatic, by the way, as well.
I know I am, but it's just, yeah, it's how I was born. It's my own royalty.
Come on, your beautiful people is Big Koi defending your right to just admit you don't know what cryptocurrency is. Guys, if I tell you the conversation I had yesterday. But yes, I'm actually sick of it. You don't know what it is. It's okay. I don't know either. It's fine. All right, then. Anyway.
It's boy, so Big Man Use, the undisputed voice of reason, aka the Oracle, the house music predictor.
Oh, do you know cool. what? That is a teaser. We're going to talk about it. Because you did your thing.
Okay.
I've never seen Iman like react that way.
He's never reacted to anybody.
Yeah, and they call me Iman, the pro-black activist.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
TDA producer, news analyst.
Give him.
And of course, 100% of the time, melanin is jam-packed.
Do you know you got Iman when you said oracle? Because traditionally, it's like an African thing. Do you get me? I think that's where you kind of threw him off a little bit.
What is oracle?
It's like a...
It's like the... I can't explain
like
that.
A fortune
teller. So you are an oracle. Yeah. Tell us what you are.
It's like the oracle sees the future. Mm. The oracle can predict what's going to happen.
You're a witch?
A wizard.
Okay. Gender specific, I hear it.
Love it.
But yeah, man, how's everyone's day yesterday?
It's good.
It was cool,
same
man.
Old, same old.
Yeah. Yeah. Positive. Good, yeah. good. I saw Chucky, I saw Savage Dan. They said, hey.
Hey.
Where did you go on after or something?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So they said, hey, I may have blamed something on Margs, but let's the episode come out first before
what?
We do it. I'm just telling him now so it's not snaky. All right, let's.
At least I'm telling him now so it's not snaky.
That's it. It's all right. Don't be scared. You know it's love.
If you say so. Well, your crypto stuff, sorry.
Yeah. Okay, so basically, so I was talking to somebody yesterday, and you know, it's got to the point where cryptocurrency and Bitcoin, all these are just part of the conversation. Yeah. But what I've realized for somebody who's like super into it is that a lot of people kind of just say it because they know a lot of people don't know.
They can confuse you.
Yeah, you can confuse you, right? So I just asked somebody who was talking really confidently. Mm. So can you just break down what cryptocurrency is? Oh my gosh, the speech that led to nowhere. And that's fine, but I was like, it's just me here. Like, you can just say.
You don't know.
You don't know. So and then we can away. Both. I walked away knowing less.
That's crazy.
I walked away knowing less, and I just feel like it was a safe space. He could have just been like, you know what, I don't really know, but I'm doing well. Whatever he could, but yeah, it is what it is. So yeah, like from now on, I'm gonna actually start saying what I want everyone to. What I'm defending people for now, like I'm gonna not just defending about to fuck it up. I'm gonna be giving examples because I'm seeing a lot of people faking it, and it's not.
No, but I love that because what I pick up from that is that when people say to me cryptocurrency now,
mm-hmm.
I'm gonna try and wrestle them and say, oh, what is that?
I just wanted to learn something. I wasn't even trying to. You know what? This was accidental rattling. I wasn't even trying to. He lost it, got sweaty.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Because this was something he was like saying he was.
Oh, man.
Right? You know, like someone asked you about TDA, you would know.
Yeah, but maybe he's built a brand on it.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's going to come out and.
He has. Stop believing no. He absolutely has.
Was
and that, I think.
Was it a guest?
A guest for the show. No. This wasn't on Halfcast. This was just somebody that, you know, right. You know, I randomly talk to people on my way to places.
Yeah, she wanted to know about crypto.
Yeah, I do. That's if you can make it fun and entertaining.
Yeah.
Diagrams and stuff.
Yeah, like pictures, a dance, a song that's catchy. Yeah, I definitely want to know about it. I know it's important.
But that's anyway. Interesting.
Yeah. A lot of people think about it. It's almost like cryptocurrency to you because you don't know anything.
I just tune out. Yeah,
you
just tune out. That's great.
Or you just kind of be like, yeah. Do you know what I mean? So
I got one of those too. Right. I got one.
I got four. But yeah. Anyway, that was my story about cryptocurrency. Let's jump into the first headline. Oh.
Okay.
Trigger warning, please. Please.
I was just about to say, like, Koi is probably the best place to even talk about this. But basically, first headline is the upcoming, well, the now happening rail strikes. So as mentioned yesterday, the biggest national rail strike in 30 years started today. The RMT union has blamed the dead hand of the government after negotiations to prevent the strikes failed. So talks were held on Monday afternoon to avert the strikes, but sides remained gridlocked, deadlocked. RMT General Secretary Mick Lynch said, what we've come to understand is the dead hand of this Tory government is all over this dispute, and the fingerprints of Grant Shapps and the DNA of Chancellor Rishi Sunak are all over the problems on the railway. Until they allow employees to negotiate freely on pay, job cuts and conditions, I can't see how we're going to get a resolution. He said massive cuts of £4 billion from the rail network and Transport for London meant thousands of job losses, reduced pensions and some staff being forced to accept salary cuts. He also talked of there being a plan to close every ticket office in Britain. However, the Department for Transport said no final decision has been made, but said it was absurd to suggest it wanted to close every single booking office. The Transport Secretary also denied the government intervening in the dispute, saying no ministers have ever been involved directly in these strike negotiations and only the employers and union can reach an agreement. He also blamed outdated unions opposing progress as a reason for the breakdown in negotiations. So the impact of the strike, how are you impacted today, bro?
If I pounce you. Here's the thing, it wasn't just a rail strike.
Okay.
It was a bus strike, a tube strike. It was an Uber strike. No, because I don't know what, this was worse than the strikes where it was just tube. Like buses were going by and not stopping. Like,
so they went to work.
Yes, but I don't know, because they were packed. So it just fucked up their whole thing. Right? So like when I say hour earlier than usual, doesn't matter, like buses and nothing that was being told to me on City Mapper or anything was accurate. I mean, as in they were vibing. They were just spitting freestyle. It was not realistic at all. And then the Central Line, you guys are even lucky that this isn't, I don't know, sorry for giving away your address, but this, the trains going in the opposite direction aren't even running. So how I'm getting home, we don't even know. So
Faith, prayer.
So yeah, it just was like super, it was way worse than the last thing. Like way worse.
I could definitely tell because the roads were packed as well. Like I was in a bit of traffic.
It was horrendous. There was a fight on the bus between a Russian woman and a black man. And I can't lie, it was matched. It was, I didn't know who was going to win. There was a fight. There was arguments because everybody was just trying to get, it was below me. And it changed my life.
And it changed my life. Experience.
It was, I said, do I even believe in TDA? I don't know. Did anything mean? But yeah, that's crazy, man.
In addition to that, what they're saying is millions of people, ranging from commuters to people heading to Glastonbury Festival, will be affected by this week's rail strikes. Yeah, businesses will also be hit, with customers unable to travel or choosing to work from home. So, according to UK Hospitality, the strikes will cost the hospitality sector an estimated £540 million across the week, with businesses expected to see a 20% drop in sales.
That's a lot.
It's crazy.
You just gotta give them what they ask for. It's too disruptive. So this small London is too disruptive.
There's not just one union though. There's better different unions, isn't it?
There's different unions.
Give in to everyone.
But I swear the unions don't even agree on things.
Yeah. Sometimes they don't. Yeah.
So what are we fighting for?
I'm gonna ask, what are they, what's the actual how much are they asking for?
Well, this guy Mick Lynch, he's basically saying he wants something in line with inflation in December when they first sat at the table.
Yeah. 7%.
7%.
Yeah. We had done this yesterday.
Yeah.
I forgot.
Didn't have to hold him up.
I forgot.
He was recapping for the people, the oracle. He can't see backwards, only forwards.
Whatever backward never means.
That's it.
My powers are, what's the word?
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm so glad. Yeah, that's crazy, man. Yeah. I'm interested in what's going to happen with Glastonbury, because I know with festivals, you have a duty to make sure people can get home after your event.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's how, like, Wireless, they always do the whole... So when you go Wireless, yeah, they let you know. So basically, the festival can't end beyond a certain time because they take into account, like, trains and all that kind of stuff.
Okay.
And then, like, they even sometimes go down to, like, the platforms to make sure enough people get on the trains and all that kind of stuff. So that'd be interesting. Because you can't have anyone come to your event and then they can't get home.
Yeah. That's so smart.
Probably your insurance. Insurance is going off. You can't get home properly.
And they will get in trouble if they're drunk and bored.
Yeah, exactly.
Something
yeah.
bad's going to happen. So that'd be interesting.
And also, just a reminder, strikes, obviously, today, on Thursday and Saturday. So it's going to be a very limited service. Trains will only run between 7:30 and 6:30 p.m. Yeah, that's pretty much the update on the train strikes.
It's not even good for your health.
Strikes?
This is terrorism. I'm going to say it's terrorism, but this is bad. But yeah, right then. What's next? Oh, yes. Okay, let's jump into what you're saying, topic of the day. All right then, guys. So, do you want to intro it? People love your voice. Go ahead.
All right. So, security or privacy? So, what more do you value? Do you see this as similar to the freedom of speech argument that freedom comes with the potential to offend? Does having true security mean there's a necessary infringement on our privacy? Does having total privacy really increase the chance of potential threats to public safety? And what really would you be giving up anyway? I mean, you're not terrorists, at least, you know, at the moment. So why do you care? So why do you care? Or is it just like the principle? Or do you feel like it sets a new precedent and this would just be the beginning? Or do you feel like the government spies on us anyway, so we don't really have a say?
What type of security are we talking about?
As in the comments?
Yeah, so like basically spying on us, listen to our phone calls,
and
communications, seeing what you're doing.
Do you believe that?
Big brother.
Yeah.
Do I believe it's happening?
Yeah,
of course, 100%.
So this was fascinated by that. This was inspired by a document. This was inspired by a documentary that had like this hacker. He got arrested, all of that stuff. Mm-hmm. But he actually was able to get out of it because it turns out that to find him, they hacked everybody in the apartment's communication and devices without them knowing.
Yeah.
And it was using a device that's been around for 30 years. And people were like, wow, like they've been able to see everything whenever they want without having to tell us because they just call it Stingray. So it's the idea that he was able to get off because he was like, you lot shouldn't have been able to get that warrant if you weren't listening to everyone's calls, that kind of stuff. But they also were able to get him for like over $500,000 on fraud. So it was like, it's like kind of like, what do you prefer more, being protected or being able to keep your secrets?
What's this called?
It's on Netflix right now. It's called Secret Web or something. Like it's very there. It's like, you know, that top 10 recommended in the UK. So it's like number 2 or something.
You
so
watched it?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Finished. I said this is the kind of things I want you to recommend to me. Not Man of God. This is the kind of things you in the group chat.
But it's really, really, really good. Okay. So, but anyway, like, yeah, like, what do you guys think? What's more important to you, privacy or you were answering first?
You know what it is? I'm trying to me, like, are you talking about, would I rather be free and open and the government not spy on me?
Mm-hmm.
So there's no need for security because I'm being left alone, or for the government to spy on me and me have security? Like, what are we saying here?
So if the government if there was like a terrorist in your apartment block, wherever, yeah. Okay, terrorist is because it's an obvious answer. But no, say there was a crime.
We've been bombed this week. Let's get to it.
Say there was a crime in your neighborhood, right? But it meant that every person in your neighborhood would get stopped and searched. They have access to all your phone calls and all of that.
Yeah.
They can do the investigation without having to do all of those things, but it will obviously take them longer and all of that. Like, what would you prefer, that they do the investigation without having rights to all of your privacy and stop and searching everybody, and you know what I mean, like police state stuff? Or would you prefer that they do have access to all of that in order to find any threat that could come up at any time?
I would prefer the privacy.
Okay.
Because you got muscles, haven't it? You feel like you can take on the criminal?
No, because why do they need to investigate me?
Fight an explosion.
Remember, no, but like
they need to investigate the threat. If I'm not a threat, why do you need access to my information?
No, but say that they're checking everyone's, like, they don't know what could get them a lead.
Yeah.
So they have to check everybody's things.
Mm.
Like, they're stopping searching your son and daughters on the way to school. Like, they
are taking your phone records.
Whatever, like, they want to do, they can do, because it's to find any possible threats in that neighborhood at all times.
Is this like a one-off investigation, or is this ongoing?
Ongoing.
This is ongoing. This is like,
you can't actually do hypothetical.
You can't be
more. No, but you know, in life, there's so many variables.
You want a whole Netflix script to eat.
Really. But all in all, obviously, privacy is important, isn't it?
Yeah.
So I would say I would choose privacy.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
I think it depends what side of the law I'm on.
I'll pick privacy, you know.
I feel like I do like privacy, but I think if it's going to like save me in something that I don't know is coming, check the records, mate.
I know, but remember what happened to Shing... What's her name? Shingen Begum?
Shimama Begum?
Yeah, her, yeah. You know. Yeah,
no,
you
but
know.
She went and joined...
No, but as in like once you say something's okay now, it can be used against you in a week, in 2 weeks, in 3 weeks. Do you know what I mean? That's like, once true. It's a slippery slope. Do you know what I mean? And we already live in a biased society. Any harsh stick is going to be used to beat us before anybody else.
But you know, I think I do like privacy, but I just think that because obviously the MI5 have done such a great job. I am for them because I know that they, like, there's so much that's prevented that we can't even think of. That's prevented because they're like in people's business, basically. Mm. So I can't imagine if they weren't in people's business. I probably get jumped my way out of here.
The thing is that police, yeah, let's pretend, okay, let's say, forget all your emotions about the police, yeah. Let's say the police was actually like a solid force that was doing everything, like by the book, whatever.
Yeah.
They would always lose because criminals are not going by the book. If you think about it, criminals are not going by the book. So if you were like a law, I'm not saying that the police should break the law, by the way. I'm just saying the way to get that intel and stuff is to be strategic, is to be like smart, is to like play.
It's with the kind them. Of, yeah.
Not really, because they got more resources.
Okay, so for instance, I obviously haven't seen the police on high levels. I just see like PC plod on the road and stuff. Yeah. So, okay, so you have like these, like I remember a scene, where there was like these three guys and they stole from JD Sports and then they started running around the police And the police guy had like a baton, right? So he, like, I'm not saying he should have, but he could have like tripped them up or whatever. But he just was running in between all three of them. Like, he couldn't break, especially with everyone looking at him, especially because it was in, like, in the area it was. You can't, now everybody would be against him, innit?
Yeah.
But he couldn't break the rules in that. But they were breaking the rules. Because he, as in, when I say rules, I mean outnumbered. Like you know what I mean?
They took
his hat. Like, it was all, do you know what I mean? And I realized he was in prison by the fact that he had to go by a certain level of rules, and they didn't have to go by rules, innit?
Boy.
They took his hat, ran in circles. He was running for ages, man.
That's so embarrassing.
It was embarrassing. It was embarrassing. And there was like an older black lady that was like to them, stop it. Like chill. Like the community leader was the one that put it to rights. But yeah, so I was thinking, how can you win in that kind of thing where you don't have to abide by the rules, if you're always having to abide by the rules? But I would pick privacy anyway, because I know I just know it's going to be used against us soon.
I think I would pick, because that was a really good, Shimama was a good example. I think I would pick privacy just because you give them an inch, boy or boy.
Mm. What about you, Marks?
Running with it.
I know, I'm always going to pick privacy, I guess.
Over security.
But it's national security. It's not my own personal security. It's probably, it's more national security. Mm. Feeling safer in the country, and obviously all the extra stuff that they do, and all the access to all your information, all the cameras, all this kind of shit. I mean, because I don't know. It's maybe a fair trade-off. People say privacy, but it's like, if you're not doing anything illegal, what are you hiding?
So what this hacker said is that what you're doing now that you think is illegal could become illegal later. Remember, at one point, being gay was something that if they found out about, your life would have been done out back in the day. Now it's cool, but things will happen in reverse. There's things that are cool now that in a little bit from now, it could be your religion. Do you know what I mean? People have to hide their religion. Do you know what I mean? So allowing like a government body that much access to you is a bit... It could get scary. It could get on top. There was this fucked up condition, like, you know, one of those scenario things that we spoke about, like, back in uni days, but I don't know if it's too... Trigger warning, HIV. Is that...
No, it's not. Yeah. You guys, we need to have a meeting after this. what trigger warning flipping is.
I mean, like, talking about...
No, whatever it is, whatever you think it is, it's not.
I don't know. I don't know what people are sensitive about, so I'm just trying to be... Anyway, so, don't take that out, because I don't know now, but yeah. So basically, the idea was... the guy was like, if everyone with HIV should have like some sort of tattoo He was like, in 100 years, if everyone with HIV, you're aware of everyone that had HIV and all of that, in 100 years, if everyone acts accordingly, this thing would be like out of society, because in 100 years, everybody, you would have moved on, passed away, all of that. And so it wouldn't be in circulation anymore. This was what that guy said, right? My friend was like, that sounds like the Star of David that people put on, like, dude, like, you, like, making people have to identify publicly with something can lead to them being hurt and all of that stuff.
So if people get marked for having HIV.
Yeah, this was the scenario the guy put forward. Yeah.
How does it become extinct?
Because it was like, then people wouldn't accidentally get it, because they would know who has it. Or they were able to use like PrEP or the different things that they can use to ensure that they could have sex without contracting it.
Okay.
So it was like, everybody would be able to act accordingly, because some people have it, don't know they have it. This will make sure that everybody knows where everyone's status.
Okay.
And then with that, he was like, within 100 years, it would be our system. That really upset the other girl in the conversation, because she was like, yo, that's literally how people end up being persecuted, because
it's
unlikely they're going to get, like, you know, it can allow for biases and discrimination and stuff like that.
But the thing is, those who don't have it, obviously they don't know they have it, so they can spread it because they don't know they have it. If you do have it, you should tell people that you have it.
Yeah.
As in, not just everyone, but if you're in a situation where you're going to have sex with someone, you should tell them.
Yeah, but then some people don't have it. Some people have it from other reasons. They don't even know they had it. So they probably got it from like a cut or something. I don't know, something. Mm. And they haven't realized that they've now got it. So they'll never think they've got it.
No, I know. That's what I'm saying.
So then they will never have the mark.
That's what I'm saying.
And then they'll go ahead, because they still don't know.
No, this would be a mass testing. Yeah, so everybody, it would be a mass testing. Everybody would have to know. Like, so everybody knows. And so if you have it, you're going to automatically get like some sort of tattoo that is very
evident.
This
is giving Black Mirror.
But this is what I'm saying. But I'm saying, this plays in, the only reason I brought it up, it plays into the security or privacy thing. Because we should the government be that inner? Like, should they even have that? Even if the intentions aren't bad, you can see how something like that can lead to like terrible things. Mm-hmm. Do you know what I mean? So that was kind of like, that's the only reason why I brought that up.
Can I ask a question? Yeah.
Yes, sir.
What if that mark was in a private area? So you wouldn't be able to see it on people in everyday life. So only when
you're opening the dick for a surprise. It's a kinder surprise.
Yeah.
And secondly, say HIV was such a crazy epidemic where the government was just forking out millions, would you still say they shouldn't, you know, intervene?
I just think
I don't trust human beings to be able to have that much information and do not evil with it. Like, I just think it will end up with like they'll be targeted, or not they'll be targeted, but like when you make, I just can see it going wrong.
I thought they end up having that in town.
The privacy argument's weird, man, because people, I don't even know what we're talking about. Like, when we talk about we want privacy or the government doing this, doing that, all the information that we give up freely is enough, is everything.
Yeah. Yeah.
There's not even no extra. Yeah. Like everything that we just give up freely that we have normally is every piece of information they could possibly need. There's not even no real extra they can get. I think the extra would be if they had cameras in our living rooms watching us 24 hours a day. That might be a bit too much.
How do we even
but
know
what else is there? What else is there that they can take that we're not giving them?
Sorry, yes, go ahead.
But how do we even know that even that that's not something we consented to already? Because when you think about your devices and stuff and you agree to terms and conditions.
Don't even read them.
We don't read them. You don't know whether it's in there. It's saying that the lens, by the way, this week, I think someone did put a thread one time on Twitter, how basically your phone does record you and it records every single place. It literally puts a pin everywhere you go, and you have to actually turn that off. So
I can't remember where it is, but there's a settings that you can go to in your phone, and it will show you everywhere you've been for the past half 3 months, how long you stayed there.
Yeah,
that your most frequently visited places. Yeah, I can't remember what it is, but you can find it.
So while we're saying, I feel like if you do privacy, you actually have to live with like a Nokia 3310 or something.
Oh yeah, off the grid.
Live in the woods. Like, you have to be off the grid. Yeah. But then
no, but I swear on an iPhone, for example, if you just turn your location settings off, then it won't do that. No.
No, I think it's still,
it still does.
Yeah, it does it regardless.
That one's a different setting. Oh. Yeah.
Someone said for Siri to even be able to respond to you, she means she must have been listening. That's when I was like,
you know, sometimes I'll be talking and Siri's like, repeat that, or she's like, oh, I'm first of all, girl. No one's talking to you.
And you know, recently people have started to have the webcam covers on their laptops.
Yes.
Everyone does
there's
that.
There's a notion that
I do that.
You're being recorded. You're being watched through your computer.
You don't do that. I don't get changed in front of my laptop anymore.
Yeah, not anymore.
Well, I'm giving someone a show. What are they going to see if they're watching me?
I think they'll see a lot.
I know, but that'll be their problem, not mine.
It's true. They wouldn't be able to actually use it directly in a court.
Yeah, but you know, I think though, because basically, I don't get changed from my laptop anymore. Yeah, because I just feel like, what if there's someone else in there? What if this is recording? And fair enough, they might not be able to use it anywhere. Mm. What if it leaks? Mm.
But the thing
now
is,
now I've got scandal. Now I'm the word on road.
I find it, even though I believe it's happening, like, so you're telling me there's a building somewhere and there's people with monitors and everyone's just, and what, they're clicking through every household to see what's happening.
I actually believe that.
You know what I'm trying to say? It just seems a bit far-fetched.
Yeah, but also, so did the testings in Tuscanegia or whatever, where they were like giving black people chlamydia or whatever, just to see, and just releasing them just to see how bad, like,
yeah, but
the government is capable of
fuckery. Years ago,
I'm not saying it's not true, but it just feels like, what are they,
what's the game?
What are they looking for?
No, but you know what is that? Years ago, it would have sounded ridiculous that police would be at one point tracking people's phones to like put a crime gang together, right?
Put
criminals together.
Yeah.
Now, thinking of video, it doesn't sound weird, because years ago, that would have sounded absolutely ridiculous. Like, you're telling me that this brick phone we have, the police are somewhere watching and listening to calls and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
But it's reality.
I know, but okay, let's just say...
Because it was Snapchat. Even stuff on Snapchat, you know. Hacked Snapchat.
Let's just say there's someone who's watching your computer.
Yeah.
After a couple of days, he's like, there's nothing here. I'm not coming back to this computer again.
There's a lot of manpower. You know what I mean? It will take a lot of manpower.
This girl does. It's just one big bang theory. Day in, day out.
And this is everyone's household. Most people ain't doing shit. So it's like, you know what I mean?
No, I heard that.
So essentially, they have, called where they look out for buzzwords.
Like, if you're searching bomb on your laptop or something.
AI that does this kind of stuff.
But you know what? When you think about what it's protecting you from, if they did have access to everybody, they would find out pedophiles real quick, find rapists real quick. Yeah. Like, it could be used for evil, but it could also be good used for real good.
Yeah. I would say security, man, because I can't afford it.
I did hear, though, if you do type in certain words, like, it's going to go off very fast. Like, they'll know.
They're knocking it off.
Yeah, I heard that. Like, if you type in bomb or something into your Google search.
I don't think they're gonna come knocking
your door.
No, not knock your door. I'm not saying within 10 minutes they're gonna be surrounded.
I've typed everything. I've typed everything.
Why?
They don't do nothing.
So you know what? You have to see what happens.
Yeah,
he said, I've tested.
Tested and tried.
Yeah. We'll finish on this year. In this documentary, there was this guy who did this thing called swatting. This is crazy, right? So if you're playing video games like Call of Duty and somebody upsets you, you know it's a very toxic environment when you're gaming and they're like calling you your mom's a slag, all of that. They go off, right? So if he would lose, he would call up the FBI and say, and he'll be like, so-and-so. So let's say it was me and G. I'd be like, my name is Esther and I just shot my mom in the head. And but in America, that would bring the SWAT team and I'm about to shoot more people, whatever. So then the SWAT team would like, go to that person's house and all of that. And this guy was doing it like repeatedly and
because of a game.
Because of gaming or because if people asked him to do it. Then he started doing like news stations and all of that. And then finally he did it at her man's house and the guy got shot because the guy was so confused and he got shot. Watch that documentary. Highly recommend. But yeah, man, this is a really interesting topic. I'm sure you guys have opinions on it. Make sure you comment in the comment section. What would you pick?
Before we go though, I beg you to experiment then. I beg you right now, type in how to make a bomb.
Please don't.
I don't think you have to do all
that. And then let's see what happens in a couple of weeks. Yeah. Just type in.
How are you saying? This is awful. Cool. You can't see what's going to happen. All right, while he's doing...
Don't do that whilst you're playing.
That's what I'm saying. Brett knows, bro. He knows.
Back when you reside.
Back to Mashtown. Hey, right, guys. Tell us below if you would pick security or privacy. Let's...
Probably still doing this now.
No, I've stopped it. I won't.
No, you're trying to erase it quickly. Then back to my space.
Let's head into the headlines.
All right, so Mr. David Lammy is under investigation. So Labour's Shadow Foreign Secretary David Lammy is under investigation for allegedly breaking rules for declaring financial interests. The Parliamentary Standards Probe is looking into possible breaches to the MP's Code of Conduct. MPs must register changes to their financial interests within 28 days. But Mr. Lammy's financial register contained interests recorded way outside of that period. The MP for Tottenham's financial register included a speech in the US on the invasion of Ukraine. It also noted he received £3,280 from the Canary Wharf Group for a speech and a question and answer session on the 1st of December, but that was not recorded until the 27th of May. So Mr. Lammy has apologized for the information not being provided in a timely manner and said he had put revised systems in place. Keir Starmer, who was a Labour leader, concurred, saying he was absolutely confident he had not broken the rules and blamed the investigation on administrative errors in his office. So yes, it doesn't look like it's really going to progress into anything. Because obviously, I think they can just tell it was just one of those lazy type of situations, pretty much, isn't it? With his office. But yeah, nothing's coming for the back, man. Yeah, man. It's because them lot have been talking so much about Boris and that, innit? But Boris is back in the news.
He probably is doing crooked stuff anyway. But I don't understand why they're going for him for. What about the rest of them?
Mm.
It's racism.
But yes, Boris Johnson is back in the news, you know?
What's he done now?
Again.
Basically submerged.
Can I say this guy's in the news every day for doing everything other than his job properly? But please continue.
It's emerged that he attempted to hire Kerry Simmons, who is now his wife, as his taxpayer-funded chief of staff.
I don't have a problem with that.
Huh?
I don't have a problem with that. That's a good husband.
But this was when he was the foreign secretary and she was Conservative Party press chief. So the story was reported by the Times, yeah, but was swiftly withdrawn when number 10 stepped in to complain about it. The story claimed his plan fell apart when his closest advisors learned about the idea. Johnson was still married to the barrister Marina Wheeler at the time. So a spokesman for Carrie Johnson said the allegations were totally untrue, whilst a down the street source described it as a grubby, discredited story. However, the freelance journalist who wrote it, Simon Waters, has defended the article. At first, the allegations were much up in the air, but on Monday, number 10 confirmed that it did contact the newspaper on Friday night and did ask it to retract the story. Because at first, allegedly, Downing Street were denying that they intervened at all. Allegedly. But yeah, they have pretty much said, yeah, they did jump in. The Times has so far refused to say why it agreed to remove the story, although its website has been flooded with comments from readers demanding an explanation for that. Dominic Cummings, former advisor to Johnson, but now his arch enemy, backed up the original story and even went further, suggesting Boris Johnson also attempted to appoint his wife to a government job in late 2020. So this was whilst he was a prime minister.
Okay.
Obviously, this has been denied by the prime minister's spokesperson.
Is this only an issue because these people aren't qualified? Or is it because they're close to him?
I think it's a bit of both, you know. You just can't do it through those channels. Like, you need to do it like, you know how you have to put the proper ad out?
Yeah.
So I think, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, but he was just trying to do some nepotism right there.
Okay. So are we discussing whether or not we kind of believe in nepotism or?
Yeah, I mean, how do you feel about it? What would you, I mean, Koi already said she doesn't think it's a bad thing.
Only because they obeyed up.
I think if nepotism works in your favor, you know, you ain't gonna mind. If it works against you, that's when you might mind, innit?
Mm.
Let's just say you're going up against someone who isn't qualified but is the son of the manager or whatever, and that person's hired because they're the son, and you're qualified, but you don't get hired because of nepotism. So, but when it works, if you're the son of the manager, then I guess you love it. So I think it depends.
Agreed.
Okay. Yeah.
Well, yeah, he's definitely not allowed to do that anyway. Yeah. So, especially as prime minister.
Yeah, I hear that.
So, yeah, man.
What if your son actually, in this example, is actually good? Because I kind of reckon as a PM, if your son is going to be there, you kind of want him to be like better than norm. Otherwise, it reflects badly on you. Like, I think it would be harder to give your son a job in those conditions.
I guess so. That's if you actually care about.
Oh yeah, that but type I still of thing. Care. Sorry, guys. It's the train strikes got me spinning. All right then. Thank you, good sir. Let's head to Word on Road. We actually need to have a thing here where we put together all the things that we've actually predicted, because we've been predicting some shit on here.
Yeah, we have been.
So yesterday on the rotation when Yusuf covered Drake's album. And he mentioned that it might be the new thing where Drake's basically... No, actually, firstly, he said that Drake probably released it. Might have released it because Beyonce's got a new album coming out.
Mm.
So he wanted to release his quicker, right? And then secondly, he said that even though it's a different sound we're hearing from Drake, this might be the new thing where Drake is kind of like ahead of everyone in thinking.
Didn't I say that?
TDA said that. I can't get the
We said it.
We collabed on that one.
I'll take that. Definitely.
They finally had a moment.
Yeah, look at them because their group chat they started 2 weeks ago. Exactly. Finally, wow. Something manifested.
I don't like these are hating King's on our group great. Chat. These are proper
it's
hating
not
on
a group chat.
Right?
It's a chat.
It's not a group chat, babe. It's not two a man. It's
a line.
Add email or bread, then it's a chat.
Yeah.
Until then, it's just a chat, babes. It's just a chat. But basically, Beyonce's got a new song. She released a new song. And it's a house song.
It is.
It's called Break My Soul.
It's really good as well.
It's really good. I really like it. And I think it's because it's Beyonce. Like, I have to admit, maybe low key,
you have Beyonce bias.
Yeah, because I don't like house.
You should. It's Beyonce.
I don't like house on a normal day. But this song, I'm really, really here for it. So, allegedly, actually, it's kind of been circulating. There's a leak that was going around. And it was actually meant to be released today, so Tuesday, midnight in America today. But she released it early because Beyonce said, you're not going to mess up my bag. So, and she released it, and it's going to be the first song of her album, Renaissance. And yeah, it's amazing. In the song, she says, B's back, and you won't break my soul, and all that kind of stuff. I think it's really popping.
Just one song, though. She ain't gone crazy.
It's not house album.
She ain't gone crazy.
No. I really hope it's not a house album, but I'm thinking it's going to be different sounds because I can't see how typical Beyonce sounds would fit with that track.
Yeah.
Because usually she takes you on a journey, doesn't she?
You know, I think because this is being titled as Act One, I reckon Act One could be house.
Not Prediction King.
You know what I mean? And it may
the
not
Oracle,
be
he told you.
A whole album. It could be like, I don't know, 6-7 songs.
Yeah.
And then Act Two could be something else. Act Three could be something else. You know?
Let me see.
I mean, because why call something Act One unless Act Two is coming?
Yeah. That's the point. The album is meant to have 16 songs on it.
Okay.
And to be fair, one thing it does say pop, but is every Beyonce album pop?
Yeah. I think that's the
kind of even Drake.
For the last thing, he definitely deserved pop anyway.
Also, I feel like Beyonce has now stepped on Drake's release. Because Drake's album only came out on Friday and now she's
Monday. Yeah, but isn't this word on road that he stepped on hers?
No,
like, as in he heard a leak. He heard a leak was coming or whatever, and he was like, "Oh."
I think he tried to release his before hers, so he can be the first. But because this is so much better than what he's released, now I think this is gonna be the talking point. Now, I don't know if you guys agree, but I don't. There's no song.
I agree. Whatever
that's
you
better,
say,
that's better than
you're this. Winning right now.
That's better than this.
It's like for real, all the assumptions about why did you just drop. And then the second I heard that song, I thought, okay.
Yeah.
It kind of makes sense now. Yeah. I can connect my own dots.
Obviously, being in the industry, he probably...
He heard that song and said, nah. Even if she's only got just the one, he heard that and said, nah, I've got a whole album of this. It's impossible I could drop this after she drops that.
You get me? Yeah.
Yeah, it reminds me of when another girl wore the same prom dress as me. So prom. But let's not talk about trauma today.
Did you turn up late?
Yeah. Ashley did. So we were sat far apart. And we went on stage to get our shots. Shit.
That's it.
Anyway.
I'll leave the event. I'll be so honest. If I ever go up to the event, can I dress the same as me?
Can I just say that prom dress was a backup dress because I got like a tailor to make my prom dress and she destroyed it. So the day before, I had to just buy a dress. So yeah, man, I've been through a lot.
You're really believing a lot of shit today.
This is therapy.
I'll lighten up with the next one. So the next one, I told you guys about Burna Boy and the shooting. It's not alleged shooting. I mean, the shooting that happened at a club when he was partying. Well, a woman who claims to be the wife of the man that was shot has come out and spoken out. So I'm going to read some of her stuff. So before that, there was kind of rumors kind of circulating about what had happened and all that kind of stuff. And so she's kind of come out to set the record straight, I guess. So she says, "We were visiting Nigeria from America and London for our childhood friend's wedding. On the 8th of June, Burna Boy and his friends opened fire at us at Cubano Lagos. My partner and his friend were shot, with both needing urgent medical care. A bullet grazed my partner's head and our friend was shot in the thigh, leaving him hospitalized and needing an emergency surgery in Nigeria." She put Nigerian caps because if you know, you know. "Around 3 a.m., I went to the Cubano Club with some of my friends. We were there for a couple of hours celebrating the newlyweds. We were about 20 at the club, blah, blah. Laughing, drinking, blah, blah. Ben and his friends came in. We were still there having fun, blah, blah. And then she said, one of Burna Boy's friends walked to me. His request was for Burna to talk to me. She said, that was the first attempt. I told him I wasn't interested in talking to Burna Boy and I am married to my partner. He came again the second time and was met with the same response. He came the third time and that caused a few of our friends to flare up as they asked why he kept coming to disturb me. There were words back and forth and one of Burna Boy's friends attacked one of our friends. And as they attacked him, the situation degenerated into a fight. As the first fight started, the security at Cubana stepped in and were able to calm the situation. As that happened, everybody was slowly going back to their section. When two of Burna Boy's friends, another fight started and the security at Cubana jumped in again. As they were fighting, Burna Boy's friends started shooting after what looked like a signal from Burna Boy. At this point, the club was in chaos. Everyone was screaming and trying to vacate the premises. At this point, I couldn't find my partner or my best friend. I was screaming for help. I hurt my left shoulder. And then they had private calls to the police, who did not respond. So they weren't allowed into the club. Let me say that before they come and flog me. They weren't allowed into the club, so it was left for us basically to fight for their lives, basically they're saying. One of our friends was trying to get Burna Boy to calm the situation, but he only laughed at him and proceeded to get in his ear whilst being protected by his security. The shootings happened twice at different times. His friends were also shooting at people trying to evacuate the club through the main entrance. They were out to kill and didn't care who got hit. My partner's head was bleeding profusely and his friend lost so much blood, he needed a donor as soon as he got to the hospital. Burna Boy left the club without a scratch and flew out to Spain the next morning.
You know how wild that is?
Very wild.
That's mad.
She's also saying, she's kind of calling out the club as well, because she's saying that the club basically only reached out to them 4 days after the event, claiming he had no idea and would do everything to get us justice for attempted murder. How are you going to know your club was shut up, sir? 11 days later, there has been no CCTV footage released by the club or even a statement to address the incident publicly. Business has carried on as usual for him. Even after leaving the club to safety outside, or at least I thought I was safe, the same man that initially approached me on behalf of Burna saw me and said, oh, you're the one that was doing Shakarabi. So basically, Shakara is doing like, you're doing guy, like you don't, if you're nice, like you're nice. Yeah, if you're nice. Then reached into his bottoms to get something resembling a gun. Luckily, at this point, my friends found me and pulled me away just in time. He retracted and got into a car and left. So to sum things up, I'm traumatized. I've broken down every day since then. The random flashbacks and nightmares, especially after seeing Burna's response. The lack of remorse or accountability is beyond me. At least two people could have died that night. Very disgusting.
Yeah.
Very disgusting. I guess what it is what he hasn't acknowledged or said anything. I'm trying to act like it's just like a rumor kind of thing. But when people are actually hurt, it's not that.
I'm glad that her partner and friend didn't die.
Yeah,
really glad, because that would just be so needless, like
unnecessary.
And I totally believe that horse. So you were the girl doing Shakara.
Yes,
that was what made that story the most valid. Obviously,
that was when
I was like, yeah, this is factual.
She ain't telling one lie.
This is here. Very factual, right there.
Yeah, it's crazy. So some baby excellence again, just kind of following up on news I kind of already delivered. Nala's baby, so Crept and Sasha's baby skincare. It's sold out online in 10 minutes.
We love that.
I'm so proud. And it's still available in Boots and stuff. And it looks very affordable. I'm very impressed by that. So essentially, it's 99% natural ingredients. And it's good for like, it basically caters to like skin needs that are really good and very pure and clean and stuff like that. And was fired because Nala suffers from eczema. So something that would work for other babies that go through that. And yeah, it's amazing. It looks really good and it's very affordable. From what I'm seeing on Boots and stuff, it's like £5.50 for 200 mil.
That's really good.
I think that's very good for very good products as well.
I think that's cheaper than, what's that company?
Johnson? Like Johnson's and stuff.
No, the other one. Avena. Avena.
Oh, Avena. Avena is expensive. Mm. Avena is very expensive. But yeah, so it looks really good and I'm proud of them for that.
Yeah.
And you were telling me about the system as well.
Yeah, the app is cold. Like, so it's called, I believe it's called Think Dirty or something like that. Anyway, yeah. And you already know they play dirty and all of that stuff. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but the app is so cold because basically it rates products by how clean they are. So I could be wrong about which number, but if it's like 10, that means it has a lot of chemicals, whatever. But if it's zero, it means it has no chemicals. So Nala rates a zero on their That's app. Sick. And so other people that want to come across as like, you know, like clean products, whatever, they would benefit from being on the app. It's a really clear system to use.
Yeah.
It's
super. I love smart shit. It's so smart.
Honestly, yeah.
And it's just easy. Do you know what I mean? So I feel like they're really into. There's two businesses that I'm seeing here that are going to do really well. So
yeah, absolutely.
That's amazing.
So yeah, just to kind of reiterate what you just said, it's 99% naturally derived. It's vegan. Like a bit of that. Eczema friendly, suitable for sensitive skin, tea, alcohol, and cruelty free, zero rated clean, no toxic ingredients, environmentally friendly, ethically made in Britain, suitable for all hair and skin types. It's amazing. It's actually amazing.
You know, the Nigerian in me is thinking, then will it work? Like, is it just good vibes in the bottle? Like,
it's just great. Like, it's just, it's pure nothing.
Like, there's nothing there. Like, so yeah.
Yeah, but it's anyway. Really, really cool, man. So, yeah. And the restock is 9 a.m. on Friday.
Wow, that's amazing.
Yeah, I'm so proud of them, man. That's amazing. But yeah, that is all for me today.
All right, then. Well, let's jump over to People's Journal.
Okay, people, welcome to my segment. I'll give you the news from an economics point of view.
This first one might actually be quick, you know. Huh? This one might actually be quick.
Boy, I didn't want to say it. But, you know. But yeah, the first thing. Primark are looking to sell their clothes online.
About time.
Well, they're basically doing a trial. So they're going to put like 2,000 goods. It's going to be like children's products. But they want to see pretty much, you know, just see so how.
It's all right. They've got good baby stuff, Primark.
No, but we were looking I need a white tee. Like, I need some stuff. But yeah.
But yeah, pretty much, yeah, that's all it is, really. They're going to just roll that out, see if it works, and then obviously incorporate.
They're going to do like a click and collect in it. So yes, you pay exactly. online, then you could go do that.
Because I'm trying to pay for delivery anyway.
You know, I hear that, but I just think with how fast their shit moves, I don't know if this is going to end up being a massive overcomplication for them. But if they can get it right, that's beautiful.
But you know, I think it'd be good, yeah, because you know, sometimes, don't you sometimes see stuff here, and someone's going from like a flagship store? And you don't have a flagship store around you.
Yeah.
So if they've got a warehouse and they're doing stuff online, it's easier for me to just get it from there.
Get good. Yeah. The things that I'm going to make a prediction, Oracle Vibes, that the website's going to be shite.
Is it going to be their website?
The website is going to be...
No, the website already is not too bad, you know.
Really?
Aesthetically.
Because of how much... No, I mean, like, in terms of using it, because of how much stuff they have, how are you going to find what you want? Do you know what I mean? I feel like you'll be scrolling for a while. But if they can figure it out,
top notch for that, you know.
So what's on their website now? You can't buy anything.
It's just like about the company and stuff like that. But I mean, like, it's easy to look at. There's certain websites you just look at, you see, go away, man.
Yeah.
But I think what would have been a good idea as well is for them to sell through other people. So say that send on ASOS or something like that. I think that would have been a good idea.
But why is it taking them so long to go online? It's not like it's a new concept.
Because they said it wasn't. I think they always said that it wouldn't
work for their business.
For their business, So but they struggled during COVID.
COVID, like their stuff, their stock was just sitting there. Yeah. Like their business lost so much money.
So much money.
You would have thought that that would have made them. So I feel like there's a real logistical problem in
that's
terms
probably
of
what pushed them to go online, man.
That's exactly what they did. They actually said COVID showed the risk of having a store only estate.
Okay.
The next thing is, and this is the last bit of information I'm going to give. But the best is Black Pound Day is launching a permanent store in Westfield.
That's amazing. That's I didn't realize that was a store. I thought it was a movement.
Yes, but yeah, it has become a store.
So who owns it?
The Black Swiss.
Black Pound Day.
People.
Okay.
Yes. The people.
White people probably own that.
Yo, that's what I'm trying to say. I want to know.
Ain't Swiss behind it?
Swiss.
K-Swiss.
Swiss from Swiss. No,
oh, now you know if Mark's in there, I'm definitely not.
Mark's from Swiss from Swiss. He's the guy behind
it. Oh, is it?
That's cool. Yeah. That's smart.
Is he?
Yeah. He started the whole thing. He
definitely.
He started 100%. Black Pound Day.
Yeah. Swiss from Swiss. Can we get him on here? Just started Black Pound Day. 1,000%.
That's sick. Investors.
Yeah.
We're trying to invest.
No, just make sure they're not Caucasian.
Would it offend you if they were?
I think a lot. There's bare like, some local, not black, like black businesses that are white owned and stuff like that. And when you like realize it's a bit like all of them hair products.
It takes the fun out of it.
Dark and lovely and all these. All these
do you know that's mad? Like, do you know your audacity though? Like, to be like, what should we call it?
Dark and lovely.
Dark and lovely, they'll never know.
What we're not. Yeah, let's call it what we're not. Dark and lovely.
I mean, but they're providing the surface, to be fair. It's a product for
there's an overhaul. Yeah, no, but there's a change happening. Like, as in, like, a lot of black people are thinking, yo, I can create this. Mm-hmm. I can make this.
Yeah.
As long as they get the service right and the price right, mm-hmm. they'll have an audience.
You would just assume that
Dark
and lovely is...
black owned.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Because what else is it?
Dark
and lovely.
So basically, this weekend marks the second year anniversary.
Oh, nice.
So that's why they're opening it this weekend. So it's going to be the 25th to 26th of June, Westfield, White City. And basically, they're going to have like 80 plus black owned brands stocked in store. They're going to be cutting the ribbon and all sorts. They're going to have live DJ performances. Danae is going to be there. DJ Ace, Fiona Hall, Timeless. So basically, they're just encouraging everyone to come down. And pretty much the whole thing is kind of like a mini department store. So pretty much they're going to be selling like hardware, clothing, skincare.
Oh, I love that.
Beauty, books, family entertainment, children toys, accessories, all of that kind of stuff.
I love that. Yeah, I love that for us. I love that.
That's good.
It's the beginning.
Congratulations.
Not on the opening day, but I'll go. Yeah. I'm going to go Westfield. Yeah. Like, why wouldn't I? I would make an active effort to go and actually go and check out the store.
And do something.
Yeah. It's the one in West.
I guess they're going to obviously change up the businesses in the store every now and again, right? Because they start with 80 black owned businesses, but it won't be that same 80 businesses for the whole time, right?
We'll
be
like,
probably just
maybe
change it, swap out. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
I kind of see it maybe growing into like an Amazon.
I was kind of seeing it like a John Lewis type thing.
Keep adding.
You know, they have to bid for space. So when I used to work in food advertising, whatever, you know, like in Tesco's, you have to bid for what shelf you're on and stuff like that. Because a shelf that's like eye contact, like eye level, is going to be more successful than one that's on the bottom and stuff like that. So I didn't realize there's like big, like, you know, like FIFA, like big bid wars, like to try and get good space in that aisle and stuff like that. So this is probably going to go in that direction, because I was thinking John Lewis as well. So
that's sick, man. So congratulations to them. That is amazing.
That's very smart.
Yes. So for those who want to go and support, it's next door to Five Guys.
But great position.
Yeah.
Always get hungry after shopping.
Yeah.
It's near the lift, lobby 3, and it's open from 10 in the morning to 8 p.m.
Too many calories.
So this is, I'm just saying, great location.
So like prime spot. It's great.
Yeah, exactly. So
is this the Westfield in Stratford?
No, one West.
White City.
I'll check it out though. Like,
maybe not quickly. I mean, it's a permanent store anyway.
So yeah, no, I'm definitely going to check it out, of course.
No, but yeah, definitely. That's amazing, man.
Sweet. Well, guys, let's go into the daily segment asking for a friend. And this one looks juicy.
Yeah. Speaking of the show.
What's that, sorry?
That's your most positive people's journal.
I'm trying.
Really are. You came with great news today.
I feel like we need to shout out.
And you know, it's why the news was great. Right. Black people was involved.
That's it. That's really true. That's true.
The key ingredient.
I like this guy.
He's proactive.
Keep him around. I like this guy, you know.
Keep him around. He's not going to be here tomorrow.
All right. So this person is gagging for Ask a Bro. But yes, look, bros need advice too. Okay. Good intro. I need marks for this one. Laughy face. I met a babes in uni and we dated for a long time. Things went further and we ended up in a great relationship. Right person, wrong time, because I was still in the street secretly. Yeah, Mom's is the right person for this one. Yes, let me even look at you as I'm saying this story. Long story short, after both finishing uni, we decided to live together and I got lost in the sauce and cheated, thinking I could get away with it. She went on my phone while I was sleeping and she left the house the following day. She woke up at the crack of dawn. Packing her bags to leave and got in the car, and I haven't seen her since. Oh. It's been 3 to 4 months since she left the house, and I can't get this girl out of my mind. I'm ready to sort my act out and be a good person. Should I continue trying to contact her, or should I charge her to the game and accept it's done? P.S. Since she's left, I've slept with some of the baddest bitches I ever have in my life, thinking it would help, but these hoes don't compare to my baby. Laugh. Because if you don't laugh, you'll cry.
But if you don't get
all the way out of here. Anyway, Muggs, he's directed it to you. So I'd like to give it to you lot's group chat. Go ahead.
Go on, Muggs.
What advice does he want? Just want to know how she's handling it.
Should he charge it to the game, or should he try and keep contacting her? And if he should keep contacting her, what should he do to try and get her back?
Oh, no, I'm Jay scared, so I can't help him.
This has been 3 to 4 months.
PSA.
I'm just saying, but
he's not. Continue.
No, because I can't give you advice on how to chase girls. I'm not an idiot. I don't know.
No, but he said that. Should he chase her, or should he just charge her to the game, babes?
He should let it go, because you don't want a woman like that anyway.
What?
She's going through his phone when he's sleeping. Like, he can't even trust her. Like, you can't build with someone like that. So you don't even want her, bro.
But if she found something that she wasn't, I mean, then I guess
she wasn't looking. She wouldn't have found anything. What's it matter? Use it, brother. You know, like I could be doing something illegal now. Yeah. If police don't go through the proper channels, it's inadmissible in court. Use it, work. Like it doesn't matter. About what was found. That's not what we're talking about. My man was sleeping peacefully, now you want privacy. Like a little lamb, and she went through his stuff. She's untrustworthy. You don't want a woman like that.
And
you know what I realized?
But he ain't trustworthy either.
But these are what are we talking about here?
What do you mean?
What are we talking about?
What are we talking about here? That's not your line to
he's
say.
Not trustworthy. Yeah, and neither is she. But which one's worse?
Neither is she.
That's, no, but, that's not the question.
I'm just directing what he's talking about.
I'm just talking about break of trust here.
Started with him.
No, she didn't know.
What?
But he broke her trust by sleeping.
But she didn't know.
She did. That's what she was trying to say. Whether she knows or not, the trust is still broken.
No.
No?
Yeah,
no.
No, obviously in her mind it's not because she don't know.
About the ass, your religious ass over there.
If
she don't have to be this person.
I'm bispy. No, look, we're just talking facts.
If you can make this guy do the right thing.
Save his life. If me and you are in a relationship and I'm cheating on you and you do not know, is the trust broken?
But yes. Do you know why she went for
how?
The phone? Do you know why she went for the phone? Because she knew.
You broke the trust. She ain't found out yet, but you broke the trust.
But you broken the trust.
No, the trust is solid. She trusts me. I trust her with my life.
What are you talking
okay,
about?
So you're being literal.
You broke the trust by cheating. She ain't found out yet.
No, but
it don't mean that the trust hasn't been broken.
Trust only breaks when you get caught.
Yeah, that's what he's saying. I don't agree.
It's facts.
No, by definition.
Okay, cool.
This is facts. The trust only breaks when you get caught.
Technically, yes, but. You in your own mind, you know what you've done, so you know you've broken the trust, even though she didn't find out yet.
Yeah, but this is good. All these loopholes and semantics.
What are loopholes? It's clear as day.
Clear. You know you've broken the trust.
I said loopholes.
She just ain't found. She ain't caught up.
He was asleep. That's been your most peaceful, most vulnerable. He was asleep. Yeah, and she's under the guise of darkness. We spoke about this. Why would she be? Why is she going through his stuff for?
You know she wouldn't have. You know this because cheating that you think is secret that she doesn't know. She obviously had some sort of inkling.
That's
not a type of way. This was just confirmation. The trust was broken when he cheated. In fact, the trust was broken. If we're going to go by your logic, which I rebuke, but if we go by your logic, the trust was broken when she realized something untoward was happening. That's why she looked through the phone. But if you want to make that the crime, to make that the crime, you should go to prison. To make that her checking through the phone the crime, yeah, you're not giving this guy good advice. He already likes her. He's laughing because he doesn't have to cry. He wants her back.
Ask if he's checked her phone.
I should ask him.
I'll just text him.
The thing is, yeah,
because you treat people how you have to be treated. So I just think.
So she should cheat. Treat people how you want to be treated. Like you understand this logic doesn't maybe because you don't care about this guy, you don't care about this girl. That's why you're giving the kind of advice that you're giving.
I genuinely believe that you can't be with a police officer. You can't go out with a police officer. You can't go out with someone who wants to police your relationship. Yeah. And that's not to say that you should be allowed to be the criminal in a relationship. Yeah. But if that's your choice, yeah, you kind of need to be able to do that, if that makes sense. You can't, like, even if you're not doing anything wrong, it grates on you when people are in relationships with people that police them and that are overbearing and that are all up in their shit.
She looked through the phone once and she left immediately. There was no overbearing. Like, she has seen her, she saw a violation. Left. She left.
I love that, by the way.
Yeah,
shout out to
Sis.
I hope
that's a
queen.
I'm
after you.
That's a queen. Yeah, I think you should let her go.
She let him go.
So okay. Accept that you've been let go, sir.
Yeah. But my thing is, you're not doing the dumb. I don't think he's going to let her go, fine. But I think if you don't want to be in this situation again, at some point you're going to have to grow. Like, you're going to have to either be with a girl where you're openly doing whatever you want to do, or stop cheating. Like, you're in pain right now. Like, you can laugh, you can be trying to chat to Margs, all of the things you want, but you basically are saying you want your girl back. And you fucked up. And you've been with the baddest bitches, the most beautiful women, everything that you were lusting after, and you want your girl back. So obviously this isn't for you. This lifestyle don't feel right for you. Stop. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah, no, I hear you. That's a different argument, but you're right, though.
I'm going to say, obviously, he needs to use his own discretion in it. He knows the girl better than us. It's been 3 to 4 months of what? No communication. One-on-one. That is quite a long time. If she's giving you no indication that she wants you back, it might be time to move on. When trying to get someone back, I believe there's a time frame. You can only try for so long, innit?
There's a window of opportunity.
For him, is this 3 to 4 months trying for too long? Or does he believe that, you know, if he carries on for a bit longer, she might budge. Is she giving you any signs to say, you know what, keep trying? Or is it cold-hearted silence? In these situations, you never know what's happening on the other side. Yeah. She could be at breaking point and he might give up before he gets there.
She gives it, okay.
So you never know. But do I recommend chasing a woman for the rest of your life? No.
Can I say though?
So at a certain point, you have to move on. If you feel like, you know what, you're just beating a dead horse at this point, isn't it?
Can I say that as a woman, yeah, any woman that goes 3 to 4 months
yeah, she's over
without checking for you,
yeah,
let it go, babes.
Not as, always, though.
No,
always.
Well, she as in like
not
dead
always.
Silence.
Not always, not always,
yeah.
Not
she's
not
been to brunches, she's got yeah. waves, she didn't text you. Like, there's just yeah. different scenarios where there was a moment she could have had a moment of weakness. No weaknesses of texting you in 3 to 4 months.
Yes, I hear you.
Not,
I
not
hear
even
you.
To say, not even to say, you know, you messed up. Just something to just open communication lines. No,
but
she
you
don't
like
do any of that.
But you don't
say she's with someone
she
else.
She packed her bag.
Yeah.
She didn't want closure.
She
packed
might be
her bag.
Dead.
She didn't say God anything. She saw what she saw. She said, all right, cool, put the phone back, got up, packed her bag, and left.
I hear you, but I've had situations where a girl's aired me for X amount of time, and then now she's banging my not now, but she's banging my door down later on. After a substantial silence period.
What, is that because you reached out or did she reach out?
No, so just to say I was reaching out, I was pursuing, and she wasn't having it. Yeah.
Okay.
And then I gave up.
Yeah.
And then some time has passed now, and now it's in reverse.
Yeah, but you see, in that situation though, you stopped.
Yeah.
With him carrying on, all it does is just, it boosts their ego of, I can keep going. But I think even if he does stop, I honestly believe that any woman who walks away so quickly and so effectively and efficiently from a situation like that, even if it gives her all the break in the world, next thing you're going to see of her on Instagram, she's engaged. That woman is not coming back. Let it go, baby.
As in, from the way this person writes, I don't even know if he was making her happy. Just from the way he's writing.
He wasn't.
As in, like, when he's saying, I've tried reaching out, whatever, I don't know if he's even... If he's trying to reach out in like a joke, I don't know if he's doing anything to make her even think to go back.
Yeah. I don't think
do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I mean,
worth coming back to.
Right. I mean, they were together in uni. Oof, not touching my lip. They were together in uni. They had a great relationship by his point of view or whatever. Yeah, I think personally, they had two different views of this relationship.
Absolutely.
I feel like for her, she was probably timing out. This was the confirmation she needed. She probably knew about a couple cheats before this one. Yeah. And for her to be gone in that way, it's legendary. I love
what
that
it
for
is. Well, some guys will say they want you back here, but sir, what am I coming back to? Because you're doing nothing to sell me on this coming back.
Fair.
Like you're not doing. Your character hasn't changed.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You're acting like this is a joke.
Yeah.
You're not acknowledging what you've done.
Yep.
You're not even saying, okay, do you know what? Let me do this. Or, bro, where's the Chanel purse at my front door? I'm not getting any of that. There's nothing.
Where's the?
You're
effort?
Just telling me to come back to a life of suffering.
Yeah.
When there's proper guys testing a baby out here.
Yeah, and you know what's mad? Okay. He's asking for her back here, but I think he just wants her back because he's used to her, not because she's the love of his life. Or
absolutely
like
not.
That.
Man's talking about he's like, out here talking to bitches. And
he's in the wrong frame of mind. I think as soon as you start seeing yourself as the victim, he'll be all right.
And also, that piece is hilarious.
What?
Because,
what? Say that? Sorry, I did that again. Really bad. As soon as he starts seeing his... Stops seeing himself as a victim.
Starts seeing himself.
Why
saying,
is he the
are
victim?
Are you saying he's the victim?
Mugs?
It's a breach of trust. I told you.
Oh, back to this again.
I can't believe that you, on top of the day, sat there talking about you're for security and now all of a sudden,
privacy.
You're for privacy. Brent, make that a clip. Please make that a clip. I'll edit
but
it myself.
Also, I think he does love her. You know why? That PS, I've been there before, you know. I've been there.
That
see,
recognize
I'm telling
that.
You, I'm telling you, when you're And it's still on. Trust me, cuz.
Just to remind you guys, a PS said, since she left, I've slept with some of the baddest bitches I ever have in my life, thinking it would help. But these hoes don't compare to my baby.
You know what it is?
My baby.
Like
my cinnamon apple.
Every time when you're in the acting, you're thinking about her.
That's wild, man.
The drive home straight after.
If she stayed, he would have treated her like rubbish. She had
he
to
did.
Leave.
We was treating her like rubbish.
That's what I'm saying.
Can you imagine?
He had
nothing to come back
to. Do you know what? Sometimes,
flourish, sis.
You're not. You might not be good enough for her. Like, and you might have to work on yourself.
And that's it. But he don't even look like he's that self-aware.
Yeah, exactly. That's cool. So just keep. If you can get bad bitches,
he come like, for, he coming for advice. You're dragging him, talking about working himself and he's not. He's cool.
that's
cool.
That's
not
good advice.
He ain't cool.
He's cool. You get bad bitches.
Yeah, but he said he's not happy with them.
He's not happy.
No, but what I'm saying that he don't need to work on himself. Like he's. Fine.
Getting a
no,
bad bitch doesn't mean that you're healed. It doesn't mean you're good.
He's not fine, Mark.
No,
you know why he's not fine? He's writing into us.
Yeah, for advice, not to be getting dragged.
That is advice, though. Work on yourself. Everyone needs to work on themselves.
Okay, fair play.
And if you're getting bad bitches and you're not even satisfied with those, babes, work on yourself heavily.
Yeah.
Get therapy.
It's a lot of work, but you finally get somebody. You've lost this one. It's okay. But
also, yourself. Sorry, bad bitches for him might not be bad bitches for someone else as well. So, you know.
Definitely. And the Oracle spoke again.
There's levels, isn't it, to this bad bitch.
But yeah, guys, so yeah, if you're asking for a friend,
shaking it myself, I've shot some of the bad bitches.
Really?
Not
the same.
Sorry, alive and well.
Sorry, Quinn.
The group. No, the group chat should be group chat. No problem. Yeah, right, guys, sorry. If you want to send in a message for asking for a friend or sis, what would you do? Send it in to 075-6484-1073. That's 075-6484-1073. Free. Now let's jump into the headlines.
Yes, so basically it's looking like 1,000 GPs are being threatened with deportation.
Not my old Asian man. Damn it.
All of them.
Oh yeah, pull up the clip. I'm still recovering from that one.
So 1,000 foreign GPs are being threatened with deportation by the Home Office in another blow to the NHS after British taxpayers paid more than 50 grand a year to train them. So the NHS in England has already lost the equivalent of around 2,000 full-time GPs since 2015, which is making it harder for patients to secure an appointment. Now, new recruits have been sent letters informing them of their removal from the UK just weeks after they finished training for their roles. Home Office rules state foreign doctors must work under the Skilled Workers Visa Scheme for at least 5 years before they can apply for indefinite leave to remain. However, GPs usually gain their certificate of completion of training after 3 years, which leaves a two-year gap during which they can they have to secure sponsorship if they want to stay in the country when their visas run out. NHS England had expected to be allowed to sponsor these doctors during the two-year period, but they couldn't reach an agreement with the Home Office. As a result, there's 1,000 temporary visas which will be expiring next year, March. A Home Office spokesperson said workers from overseas make an invaluable contribution to our NHS, helping to keep vital services running and save lives. Trainee GPs may use the time between the end of training and the end of their visa to look and apply for work. So I think they will come up with a solution, because obviously that would be a crazy blow to lose like 1,000 potentially.
Yeah, because this UK is embarrassing.
Yeah. So self-destructive. So self-destructive.
Yeah, but I think they'll definitely come up with something, man.
I hope so.
Yeah. And the next headline is about our brother, Anthony Joshua. Yes, so the rematch with Alexander Usyk has been confirmed. Joshua versus Usyk 2 was originally planned to be held in May, but the ongoing situation in Ukraine put that on hold. Usyk actually traveled home to Ukraine and joined the military in the defense of Ukraine after the Russian invasion, which began in February. The 35-year-old, however, has now received permission from his country's sports minister to return to his training camp in gear up for the epic rematch with AJ. The fight was expected to take place in late July, but the exact date is now set to be Saturday, August 20th. It will take place in Jeddah, Saudi Arabia, but the venue has not been confirmed yet. Obviously, more details of where and how you can watch it will be given closer to the time.
Who won last time?
Mr. Usyk.
I'm not gonna lie. Until I see AJ fighting Tyson Fury or Deontay Wilder, I don't care, bro.
I was gonna ask that. It seems like the fights that people want to see
ain't happening.
Is that down to? Is
a lot of politics.
Yeah, a lot that goes into it.
I'm not playing it down, but it's a fight, right? Like,
I just go at it.
But it's the money that's involved.
Oh, so they need to be
making money. Who has a belt? Yeah, who just so came much. Off a win? Is there something different?
It's like you being a great boxer, right? And then somebody else, Esther's up and coming.
Yeah.
You've got all the belts. Mm. I make 10 million from you. This person makes 10 grand. Mm. Great boxer. Mm. Why would I risk my fire losing to her?
But if you think you're that great,
it's a risk. It's unnecessary.
So that scenario. But what about with AJ and Tyson? Fury and Wilder? Mm.
They also listen to each
other. Yeah, by now.
Yeah,
a couple times by now.
I agree with you. But it's kind of a similar principle, because both of them are represented by different agents. Mm. So you don't want your fighter to lose. And if it's something where we're going to risk our fighters, let's make sure the money is worth it.
So this stalling thing they're doing just means that when they do have the fight, we know that both of them are eating. All three of them will be eating very, very well.
It'll be like Pacquiao Mayweather. By the time they fight, they're going to be like 50.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
These ain't making the fights that they want. Obviously, there's money and stuff involved, but this is where fans get upset on as well. Because there's bare politics and red tape behind the scenes. But I think facts are, man, if they both wanted it,
You'd get it done.
Yeah, for sure.
That's why people get annoyed, didn't
it?
And so for whatever reason, okay, cool, it don't make sense for me to take you now. Let me go get this back. And you've got whatever excuses you got.
Yeah.
But for like pure fighting, this is the fight that needs to be happening.
Yeah,
you ain't doing it. This is bullshit, man.
Yeah, but I'm hearing Tyson's up for.
Tyson Fury's up for it as well. But I mean, at the moment, he wants to retire, though,
isn't it? No, he's come out and said he's not retiring again, isn't
it? Oh, yeah.
He wants to fight. He wants to AJ and all that. Well, I don't know. I think his wife come out. There's been stories come out where he's been backtracking. He was saying, talking about the exhibition fight. Was it with Ngannou? And then I see a story. I didn't read it, but I see the headline talking about he was backtracking and talking about fighting one of these lot or whatever.
So with this 2 year, who's got the belt at the moment? Or belts?
Usyk took AJ's belts.
How many?
I think 3 at the time.
Oh dear.
Yeah.
So he's trying to get it back. So if he gets them back this time, does he get 4?
No, he'll just have these 3 belts. No, he hasn't got any at the moment. So he'll just get what he lost back, basically.
So how do you add to the belts?
By taking somebody else's belts.
Oh, okay. So say he fought like Fury or something.
Exactly.
Then he'll have like...
To be fair, him, AJ and Fury should be the next fight after.
Yeah, yeah.
After this, really.
Yeah.
If AJ wins this, obviously AJ just... I mean, sorry, AJ. Fury just come off of beating Wilder.
Yeah.
So it makes sense.
Yeah.
Well, the loss killed him, innit? If he won, they would have fought, I'm guessing. Or would you reckon he would have to do a rematch again?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Sorry, not after Wilder. Who was Fury's last fight against?
White. Yeah. Okay. So it's one of those ones, man. But to be fair, we can't overlook Usyk. Because Usyk is a serious fighter, man.
No, he is, but you know it is name brand sometimes, isn't it? Like We don't care about Usyk. We care about Deontay Wilder and Tyson Fury.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, but then Usyk's doing well though, because he got the 3 belts.
Exactly.
Again, name brand.
Well, when they decide to invite us, I'll pay more attention to.
No, but you did well though, because you're like, I heard Fury said, I said, I came in his sports.
I hear, you know, I talk to boys sometimes.
Range, honey.
But yeah, is there another headline that you want to share with us?
You know?
Well, then, let's go into Love. Let's go into Danae. Right, Margs.
Who's done it this week? You know what it is, yeah? This Egypt girl just keeps talking, man, and I've had enough of her, man.
How do you think we feel?
Huh?
I think I feel when I see this doc every week.
Four monies, please.
Yeah.
Amber Heard won't stop her foolishness, man. Like, she won't stop her foolishness. She's just gone and done an interview, NBC, and she's doubling down on her story. Remember, she lost it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's weird. She won one, then lost one, innit?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right, cool.
So she's won one.
So she lied then?
I just, like, in my head, yeah, just strictly strategically, what else is she meant to do?
Keep quiet. Go on.
If you lost a defamation trial, yeah, from that means the stuff that you're saying about someone's not true, yeah, and you went through the whole big case, it all played out, we all saw it,
yeah,
mm-hmm. and then you lose it, yeah, and then you go away, go back to your business, and then the first time we see you again on TV, you're doubling down with this same story. Like, she needs to let it go.
I think it shows that she's...
No, but you know what, at this point, even if it's the truth, like, no one believes you. You just gotta allow it now. She made Kate Moss come out of her yard and give evidence, you know?
It was via Zoom. She was still at home. Like, I don't think that's the biggest issue.
No, but it's the same.
When do you see Kate Moss? She minds everything.
Yeah,
it's the same
kind of thing, though. You don't see Kate Moss. You don't see Kate Moss. She dated my man years ago. Didn't they break up in like 94 or something? My old, you know how much man she chops is 94? You bringing me to court for my old things. Like, this is mix up about he pushed me down the stairs and then he didn't push her down the stairs. He helped her. He helped me. Wow.
And then he helped her fall down the stairs. Like,
you are the worst lawyer. Amber Heard might have a point. Okay, I hear what you're saying.
She fell down the stairs and Johnny Depp helped her. It was when they was on vacation in Jamaica.
So how did Amber Heard hair?
She's a fucking bitch. She's saying, yeah.
How did Amber Heard hair?
She's saying, yeah. She was arguing with Johnny Depp by the steps, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then her sister came, jumped in between them, jumped into the line of fire right at the top of the steps, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And like he was like pushing and swinging for her sister. And then instantly, I just couldn't help but think of Kate Moss. You get me?
But why is Kate Moss in
why
it?
Because apparently Kate Moss, he pushed Kate Moss down the stairs. Remember, that's the story that she's saying, isn't it? She's saying he pushed... She knows he's abusive. He's got history of this. I remember he pushed Kate Moss down the stairs.
Okay, and the moment she mentioned Kate Moss, no, then the other side could go and get Kate Moss to come.
Yeah,
to
and then Kate Moss come and said, listen, stop your foolishness, man. No one pushed me down those stairs, Rico.
Okay, do you know what though? But did Kate Moss ever come out and say, I was pushed down the stairs?
No.
So she just heard Johnny say, I remember when I pushed Kate down the stairs.
No, maybe there was a rumor about it, because I think she did drop down the stairs.
Oh, her.
So probably there is some rumors.
So she tried to put two and two together. I got 32 and then said, oh, that's wrong with it.
She's just going ham. She's just trying to. She's just trying to kill my man. Just trying to drag him through the dirt, innit? And I think she's just extra hurt.
I wonder
more.
If they hate each other or if it's just like a.
Maybe like a love.
I feel like she hates
like
him, but
thing.
I don't feel like he would hate her.
Yeah,
because I feel like he's just happy. I feel like he looks happy to just be done with this.
Yeah,
but she looks like she, I mean, all these tours she's going on. I feel like she's happy to have the venom in there.
I think he must absolutely hate her by now, innit?
You think?
If he didn't before. But obviously she's just saying she just wants to be seen and heard, and she just wants to be seen as a human being. Mm. You know what I'm trying to say? And she's upset. Like she's scared at the moment. She's really terrified just with everything that she's going through. And she doesn't want like the way she's been treated in this case to stop Johnny's other victims from coming out, like his exes and stuff. Like basically his exes are gonna see what she's had to go through this trial, and then they're gonna stay silent and let him get away with this. Which is fucked up.
Fair point.
It's not a fair point. He ain't done this to none of his exes. No, none of his gal are saying anything. It's just her. She's probably trying it.
We'll never know now, innit? She says that no one's going to talk. So now if no one talks, it's just consistent.
You're going to let her spin that narrative?
No, I'm just... Mr. spin on of narrative. You yourself, yeah. All I'm saying is she's going to try and defend herself. Like I said, I don't even know the court case fully and all of that stuff, but the verdict is she was lying, she's guilty, all of that stuff. But she's going to come out and double down, of course, if she genuinely feels like she's telling the truth.
It's so vindictive, man. Let me see if I can...
But I do think that if she's lying, sis, she should have just gone into hiding, man.
If she's...
I just hope the world forgets at some point and just try and get
jobs. I don't think the world would forget, and the job she would get wouldn't be what she's used to. What was she doing before?
She's still on that show, though, isn't she? Do you know if the petition... So when there was a petition for her to be taken off the show.
Oh shit.
Has that happened? Does anyone know?
Uh-uh.
The Marvel film.
Yeah. I think that guy was basically against it though, isn't it?
Against her being taken off?
Yeah. I think he gave them an ultimatum, if I'm not mistaken.
Because she's gonna need the money anyway to pay back.
She owes him 8.3 million.
But I don't think he's gonna even need that money. So I think he just likes the fact that his name's been cleared. Do you know what I mean? Yeah. That was his biggest priority. I don't think he really I actually think this is what I'm saying. I don't know if he hates her, because he's on a I've heard Kumbaya. Stuff that he's on a She can't, I'm not going to press it. You know like how 50 presses stuff, like 50 presses stuff, innit? If you owe him money, you owe him money. I feel like with this, my name has been cleared. That money is just arbitrary. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? Get it to me when you can. I'm good. Do you know what I mean?
Cool,
I think that's the kind of attitude I feel like he has towards this whole situation. But yeah, got his name cleared, so.
Well, I'm glad he got his name cleared. Because she said, the things she's saying about him are serious. So the fact that they've came out and said it's not true is good, because it could go wrong, like, especially if she's lying, because she's saying like he's been battering her and all these kind of things. She's saying she's been beat. She was getting beat for so long. She forgot how to defend herself or something like this. There's stuff that she said, and she's actually said she's going to stand by her testimony to her dying day. Mm. She doesn't care. I know what happened to me. I'm a survivor.
Why are you laughing? She's a liar, man. She's a liar.
I do hope this is the last time I see in this doc. Because I'm tired.
Same, for real.
I'm tired.
We've heard.
We've actually heard this.
Like, yeah, we've heard you, man. We've seen you. You got what you wanted. You've been heard and seen, man. You're done at here, man.
The surname is so... It's just so unfortunate.
Yeah, very.
Amber Heard. Oh, shit. All right, then, guys. With all of that, it's time to go into our interview of the day.
Yes.
The one about... Yo, beautiful people, welcome to the sexiest part of the segment, the sexiest part of the show. There we go.
That's it.
I am super excited to introduce that. We have an interview today. And I like to touch the mic. And this one is about Priscilla. Okay. So let me intro Priscilla. Yeah, we're going to cut for her in just a second. Let me intro her. Model.
Okay.
Presenter.
Okay.
Ugandan princess.
Okay.
Secretly Nigerian.
Okay. Okay.
Best skin I think I've seen. I think better than Marg's.
Yeah,
I think better than Marks today.
Absolutely.
Go on, Marks, what's your verdict?
No, you might. It's up there.
Yo, thank you so much for joining us today. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling good. I'm feeling happy.
Feeling well rested.
I felt the stare off though. He was like, wait, whose skin's back? Yours is good still. I'll give you that.
Good still. Yeah, you dropped a rank, you know. We used to talk about it all the time. Yusuf, you've got fantastic skin as well.
It's all right. It's been tarnished with the sun.
Is it not tarnished?
Yeah, like, I've got some burns on my forehead and that. But
this is why I told you guys to wear SPF.
No, I didn't. I didn't that day.
Kind of put them on.
Do you wear SPF, Priscilla?
I do. Black girl sunscreen.
Okay. Can I just say, someone in here that begins with E, ends with polygamist, he...
Oh, now you meant me.
No, I sent you the link. He doesn't believe in wearing sunscreen.
Why?
That man over there.
Why?
That's the...
Everything we don't like about him.
But before we jump into the actual interview, we have a game called 140. Not 160, child. 140.
Okay.
And this is where we ask you questions, and it's gonna be very quick. It's gonna be to the beat. It's gonna be 1 minute.
Mm.
And you're gonna be on a league table if you get enough of these, right?
Is there a prize?
Love.
I'll take it. I'll take it.
All right, then can we start the music? What is your favorite Idris Elba role?
What rapper passed away 25 years ago?
What the hell? I don't know.
Who is the second in line to the Queen?
Charles.
What is the number one selling game console?
Fortnite. Console, PS4. What number are we on? PlayStation.
What British actor stars as Franklin Stage?
Idris Snowfall.
Yeah.
We know that one.
Portuguese women or Spanish women?
Portuguese.
Apple or Android?
Apple.
What's the capital of Ghana?
Accra.
How many centimetres in a metre?
100.
How many millilitres in a metre?
I'm going to go 100.
Which grime artist headlined Glastonbury 2019?
2019, Stormzy.
Beyonce or Rihanna?
Beyonce.
Lionel Messi or Ronaldo?
I don't care.
Good.
Who recently became the new host of Catfish on TV?
Nella Rose.
What TV network broadcasts these segments?
BBC. Woo, give it to me. I want that last one.
You got that last one. Yeah.
We have one more question.
One second.
Wait, she didn't do what?
Oh.
What?
What happened?
Mark. Like, I thought she dropped a joke and I missed it. I thought everybody missed it, it wasn't.
So you silenced the room because of that?
That was a serious joke. That was a serious joke.
What was the joke?
Well, the last answer.
BBC.
And then she said, give it to me. I want that one.
Oh, you nasty.
In the morning.
I thought she was nasty. I was like, well, okay.
You're really aware.
Keep it PG.
Let's keep it wholesome again. We ask all our guests one additional question.
Funny. Oh, no.
Okay. When you're buying apples, are they loose apples or bagged apples?
I don't buy apples.
Okay, fair. Okay. That's the first time I've heard that.
No, I don't.
You don't buy apples?
I don't buy apples.
But if you were to buy apples.
If I were to buy apples.
In a bag or loose?
Loose.
Claim it, Esther.
Spot me, please.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Esther,
I want to
pick each apple.
Okay.
So I'll do it loose.
There you go.
You are a queen. You definitely have Nigerian blood in you.
Can I just say, depending on what the guest says, Esther decides she's going to be honest.
Yeah. They make fun of me for buying loose apples.
But what's wrong with loose apples, though?
It's a madman move.
Ask them.
You don't want to actually...
Because
people touch the apples. And
you know what? That's a good point.
What?
People touch the apples.
Yeah.
Like, loose
gonna,
ones, yeah.
Why are you not going to wash them?
But
they're still pre.
Sometimes you don't. No, you rinse it.
What?
Sorry, let me not slander your name.
No, you
rub it on your shirt, innit?
Shine in the apple.
But yes, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
We have so many questions. Do you want to put your seatbelt on?
Yeah. I'm strapped up.
I'm ready.
Okay.
Did you sign any like NDAs or anything, or you'd have to give us like Love Island information?
I'll give you whatever you want.
Disclosure. You are a girl after my own
heart. This is a great guest.
Great guest.
This is a Lippy. No, I'm joking. Lovely. This is a great guest. Okay, what you been up to?
Recently,
yeah, because we saw you on stage. Dancing, showing skin with Hema, looking beautiful, Denise.
Yes.
What are you doing? More singing in your future?
If you see me on a track, just make sure you not stream it so I can get some views. But other than that, no, I've just been literally outside, enjoying myself, plotting, scheming, trying to work. And yeah, that's about it.
Plotting and scheming. What's in your future? We know you're a model. We know that you're a presenter. Is there something exciting coming up soon?
There is something very, very, very exciting, but I just can't talk about it yet.
Why are you teasing us?
I know, I know.
Not her coming out, I'm going to say whatever.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
No, that's, not
the,
that.
That's the one thing I can't say, but it is very exciting. With, I love like, that. Two other girls. Yeah, it's going to be sick.
Oh, that's so good.
Yeah.
Ooh, that's like a group.
Yeah, a group thing.
Is Denise one of them?
Singing group.
No, she's not.
Oh.
It could be.
I think it is.
Ooh. I don't know if you can you
Oracle,
sing?
Do I look like I can be in a girl band?
Yeah. You can dance.
Yeah, you definitely do.
Yeah, that's probably as much as I can do.
Yeah. All right, let's go back in time a little bit. Let's go to Love Island, which is absolutely, what, yeah, that's the way the world was first introduced to you.
Mm-hmm.
Can I just say, I really rate the fact that you went on Love Island. As in, when people ask, would you ever go on Love Island? I think we've asked each other this before, and we've always said no for different reasons,
yeah,
I think.
Yeah.
My reason is I think I would feel the pressure of like, wanting to like not embarrass myself, not wanting, do you know what I mean? All the judgment, all of that, the African uncles, the African aunties,
yeah,
my mom, my friends, all of that. So like, I love the fact that you actually went and had a good time. But can you tell us a little bit about what made you apply?
So I didn't apply. So originally,
she got like, she got like that.
That's how you know you're a bad bitch.
She got it like that.
They said, "Did we want
they
you?"
Said her. They said, "Please, Priscilla, please."
So like originally my stance was like, you lot, I would have never applied for the show. Like I was like, me, Love Island, kissing on TV. Are you mad? No, not happening. But then I went to Miami, started taking bikini pictures. As soon as I landed, I got a DM from ITV like, yo, there's this show.
Oh,
like,
wow.
Yeah, they was just like, we think you'll be amazing. Mm. I didn't think it was Love Island because they didn't say it. And the summer one had just gone. Mm-hmm. And then I actually thought they wasn't going to contact me because I was traveling to Uganda. And I was like, I'm available. Talk to me. Like, I want to do a TV show.
Yeah.
Let's do it. And then they finally hit me up and was like, yeah, it's Love Island. We think you'd be great. Would you consider it? Of course, I was like, rah. Me, Love Island, not really looking for love on TV. But I asked my brother, I was like, yo, can I go? He was like, yeah, secure the bag. And I was like, all right, cool.
Okay.
I'll do it.
Pretty Where much. Did you go in Castle Moore?
Yeah, yes. She was a Castle Moore babe.
Do you know that was your elite? Babe. Because they keep the baddies for Castle Moore, you know?
And you know what? I'm going to come back to that question. I want to know whether there's a hierarchy
of girls.
Yeah, because I feel like if you're Castle Moore, yeah,
mm-hmm,
the viewers know the Castle Moore babes are the elite babes.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I wonder if people know that in the house, contestants, do you know that?
I don't think the contestants know that. So like when we got back in the house, the original girls, the original people, they think they're like elite. Like, we started it. This is our house. You're coming into our villa kind of thing.
Okay.
But then I think you do kind of see sometimes the caliber of girls are better.
Talk that talk, Nigerian girl. Talk.
In Casa Amor.
Yeah.
Than the starting lineup.
What percentage of like, what percentage of what happens, like when you watch back, say like your time in the villa or whatever, even like the Castle or more, but like what's the percentage of what actually happened makes the TV, if that makes sense?
Oh, I would say easily maybe 30% makes TV.
Wow.
30-40%.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And the order that it's even delivered in sometimes that
didn't. No way. So they're chopping and screwing and
chop, screw, T-Pain on that shit. Like literally.
So you're watching them put things in, like present it, and it didn't happen that way. So it's like certain narratives, isn't it?
Mm-mm. I had one experience. So I did, it was a game show that me and Mike did.
Okay.
And this was before we even started the game. He did one joke, one dead joke still. But and we didn't, obviously they're recording 24/7, so they can use whatever they want at any time.
Yeah.
You already signed that away. So he did it, and I was vexed at him from the beginning. But what they made it seem is they took what he did and put it like halfway through the game. So when I was watching it back, I was like, what? When did that happen?
That didn't happen like that.
And because they're always filming everyone's reaction, they can put anyone's reaction at any point in time. So sometimes certain situations look worse than others.
Mm, okay.
So you're telling me they're Brent.
Your words, not mine. Yours.
So how organic is it then? Is it kind of like a little bit scripted in parts? Is it like, you know what I mean? How was the experience?
Definitely not scripted.
Yeah.
Okay.
But what I would say it is, it's their story, our words.
Okay.
Their story.
That is
words.
A
okay.
great
so
take. Yeah.
At times, do they almost set a scene? Like, Priscilla, Mike, please come over here, sit down over here. All right. Please talk about something to do with this, and then action kind of thing.
That's something that's fun out of it.
Yeah.
I mean, it takes the fun now when I watch reality TV. I'm like, oh, they probably got told to sit there. They probably got told to say this. How many takes did they do of that?
Yeah.
Like, can they go again? And so, yeah, that kind of took the fun out of it. But other than that, you get used to talking anyway, because that's all we can do. We don't have no phones, no music. We don't even know the time. We get told to wake, when to wake up, when to go to sleep.
Really?
Like every, I call it a glamorized prison.
Yeah.
And it's work. You do night shift, we do day shifts. Just depends on whatever.
It's sounding a bit gruesome.
Yeah.
It was work. No, I'm not going to lie. It was literally like work.
Did they give you alcohol?
2 cups a night.
That's it.
Rations.
That is it. What about, and, during, and during the day, you can't drink?
No drinking.
So it's just, I couldn't live there.
They're not asking you to live.
You're not going to know, though. Like,
cold sober. This is crazy.
So, one second. So, how do you, like, you know, cultivate organic relationships with people then, and trying to find love in this orchestrated prison type of environment? Like, you know what I mean?
I always compare it to like a holiday romance.
Okay.
So, with us, it's because you do everything together. You literally sleep, you everything, eat. Go to it, like all your worst habits you will see. So when you're with someone 24 hours a day, you're either going to end up loving them or you're going to end up hating them. And usually all we have is our conversation. We'll end up talking about the most random stuff ever, because otherwise there's nothing. You're just going to sit in silence. But it is that genuine, when the camera or when a conversation is focused on other people and we just have to sit outside, then it's just like, yeah, we have nothing else to do but bond. So I feel that's when we feel like, oh my gosh, I really, really like this person. Because at the end of the day as well, we don't have any outside interference. So I can't be like, oh, I'm going to go chat to my girls, I'm going to chat to my mom, I'm going to go to work, I'm going to go to this. It's literally you just and that person. So that's why people are usually like, oh, I'm so in love.
But can I take it back, sorry, to you going on the show?
Yeah.
How did you tell your mom?
Oh, my mom, I always say she's a Hollywood mom. Okay. Like, she loves it. Like, she's always supporting me in everything I've done.
That's really good.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So for her, she's like, oh, my daughter's going on TV. And that was literally it.
I love
so
that.
She was just gassed for me from the beginning.
Did she watch it, like, while you were there?
Oh, yeah. Every night, 9 p.m., because I was Kassar, so I got to watch everything.
Oh, we were literally, you get to watch it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So we would literally sit down whilst I was still at home, like, together. It was like our bonding time.
I thought, yeah, people that go Casa More, you don't get to watch the show beforehand, because it might, like, you might play games kind of thing.
They come in
knowing who they want
and
referencing stuff that's happened before.
Yeah.
All the time. Yeah.
Even when I was in, like, holding, they'll be like, okay, watch this. This is what's happened. So you know what you're going into.
Yeah. Do you think they do that with the first, you know, like, so before Casa More, the people that go in later, someone like Ekin-Su.
Ekin-Su knew.
Yeah.
It's only like the first starting lineup, because they want that initial reaction.
Yeah.
Even like the Casa More girls, we were all separated until we were going into the traveling into the villa.
Oh, so you don't meet people beforehand?
You don't meet people.
It's only, so you never knew who they was at all?
No, you don't know who the other girls are.
Oh, but then how early do you have to go into the island? Like, how early do you go to the country that is being filmed in?
I think I left 4 days before.
So they keep you on your own for 4 days?
Yeah, we were strict. Like,
can you talk to family and stuff?
No, they take, as soon as we got to the hotel, they took our phone away.
Wait, that's the real prison.
It's quarantine. Even outgoing, like quarantine. We couldn't go outside, because it was like, just in case the girl sees you. Like, so we had like 1 hour shifts. Like, you can go to the pool for 1 hour, you can go to the gym for 1 hour,
that's
come
crazy.
Back so you don't bump into the
but
other
you
girls.
Were excited. Were you excited? Were you nervous? Were you, at any point, were you starting to regret?
So I was nervous before. When I was there, I was excited. But before I went, I remember I was driving in my car and they did the first initial lineup, and I was going through like the comments and stuff, and I had a panic attack while I was driving.
Yeah.
It was mad, because I think I had Sophie Piper, one of the Saturday Girls' sister.
Yeah.
They was just like, oh my gosh, she's so skinny. Can you not just get regular girls? And I'm like, but I am. I'm skinny. Do you get what I mean? Shit. I'm small. And then I started thinking, oh my gosh, are they going to think I'm too skinny? Are they going to think I'm too dark? Like, what's going to happen? Like, why am I throwing myself out into this situation?
Yeah.
And then I just had to chill. And I was like, no, it's cool. I got this. I'm on it for a reason. Let's go.
Did got this.
Were you happy with the response you got?
You got it.
Yes, I was. I literally, if anything, I think I only got like 2% negative.
Yeah.
Everything, like, from being in, it's coming out, I have received nothing but love. So
you conducted yourself really well.
No, you did. Honestly, like,
you're an elite. Nothing. Grade. You weren't a Gemma, but we'll talk about that.
I'm gonna ask if Mike moved to you on the outside world.
Can I ask a question before you ask that?
Okay.
When you were going to the house, did you know who you wanted to speak to?
Yeah.
Who was it?
It was Mike.
Okay.
He was the only bad boy in the house.
I'm thinking. Is there an element of like Stockholm syndrome? Like, you're trapped with this guy for 24/7, so you're almost forced to like him. But if it was on the outside world with other men as well, you know what I mean, playing the field, whatever, would have he have
appeal to you?
Appeal to you as much, you know what I mean?
I love this question. You
no, it's great. In the house, I think he was definitely the best of the bunch. Mm. In the outside world, what I'll say is I definitely think we are two different people.
Yeah.
And I think face value, I think he is very good looking. Mm-hmm. But the more I got to know, probably not.
Okay.
Probably not in the outside world.
Because he seemed like he was interested in, what's her face?
One of the twins.
One of the twins as well.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
Jess.
You smiled.
No. I said, yeah,
Jess
I watched
and
it.
Evie. That's it.
I was watching it with you guys. Yeah. So I was like, right, yeah, he's interested.
He was coupled with Jess prior to you,
I think,
right?
Yeah.
Yeah, they started talking again.
They were talking.
Just before I came in.
Was that before Leanne?
I'm not sure.
But that was a lifeline though.
So obviously his taste is, you know, it's a broad spectrum, right?
Yes.
Did you ever question that?
I remember, yes. Sorry, I'm so sorry. That was very dramatic. I'm sorry. I have memories. That was a lifeline. Yeah.
That was a lifeline though. Was that his taste or was he just trying to stay in the house?
But like, did you question how much he was into you because of who he was with before
beforehand,
you?
Beforehand, yeah.
Because he was with Jess and Leanne, I didn't question it so much. I was like, he's from Manchester regardless. So obviously he most likely will like white girls.
Yeah.
But because he was with Leanne, I was like, okay, maybe he does like black girls.
Okay.
And then like when we was in the house, was literally like, was doing stuff like was singing Afrobeats and getting told off for singing and stuff like that. So I was like, oh, okay, like.
You can't sing.
He passes the vibe check. You can't sing.
So they really want you to have no statement.
No. Yeah,
You can't sing. Nah. Even the slaves have got to sing. Sorry.
Oh, no.
But they got to sing, I'm just saying.
I'm glad you said that, not me.
What do they mean you can't sing? I get, because obviously they're not going to play you singing certain songs on television. Yeah. But they just don't use the footage. So what you'll be singing and they'll just like, cut that out.
Yeah, they'll just be like, stop.
Is that because they're filming or you can't sing, period?
Yeah, but just don't use the footage. Like, what do you mean don't sing?
Yeah.
This is why he can't be on the show.
Yeah.
He's already ugly.
What do you mean?
Also, you know, in the villa, in the house, how many cameramen are there around you guys? Like,
Good question. Okay, so you have like CCTV footage.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then you'll have like physical like cameramen. So I just want to like imagine that can slide open. So there'll be a camera in there. So they'll just slide open and then they can just twist it to focus on anything.
Oh, so it's not actual people.
So there's not actual people. But there's people manning the cameras, but they're like in the bushes, in a cupboard, in something else, and they're just doing different shifts.
Talk to you through the little people.
Cameramen don't even talk to us.
Oh, don't they?
No.
But I could tell you something about what's going on outside.
Yeah, we have something called a VOG. Yeah. It's kind of blasphemy. It's called Voice of God.
Oh, no.
And it literally talks to us from a tannoy, from the sky.
Oh, really? Oh, like Big Brother.
Yeah.
Also, I heard there's a lot of like hanky-panky that goes on, but it just doesn't make the final edit. Yeah. So as someone who's inside the house, how much real hanky-panky goes on?
Well, for myself, look at me, I'm like, I don't know.
Okay.
But apparently,
yeah,
it was happening.
But y'all are in the same room, no?
We're all in the same room, but we're stretched.
Yeah, because you're here, see?
You can hit up. When I went to sleep.
I'm not hard day's work.
I was tired. But no, it does. Because they're like, it's a family show now. So they can't show that stuff anymore. Because kids are watching, grandparents are watching, all of that sort of stuff. But no, it goes down.
Did you want to find love on there? Or did you just go for the vibes?
No.
Okay, so you're a realistic babe.
Oh, yeah, 1000%. No. That was never the plan.
Okay.
So, like we said earlier, we feel like you carried yourself really, really well. Mm-hmm. At one point, I think you were wearing like a kente cloth kind of bikini. Mm-hmm. I want to say that I didn't clock this. Our producer did.
Thank you.
Just
thank
put
you
that into the world. Just, yeah. But it seems like you were embracing the fact that you were African and black in a way that I hadn't really seen done on Love Island. Was that intentional? Was that like, yeah, did you? Like, yeah, you just tell me.
It wasn't intentional. One thing I just wanted to do was go in there and be me. Mm-hmm. So like, okay, yeah. Ashanti Swimmer, like I absolutely love their swimmer. Mm-hmm. I even modeled for them ages ago. So it's like, if I'm going to go in there, I'm going to do the same thing I do on the outside. If I go to the beach, I'm going to be wearing that. I change my hair like every other day. So I'm going to change my hair like every other day when I'm in the house. Yeah. It was just like, do me. And if everyone else resonates with it, then sick. But this is what a black girl does. So I'm going to do me.
I love that. I was going to ask about your hair because I loved the fact that, because I feel like, obviously I know there's a lot of pressures when black women go in there about their hair and stuff like that. But I feel like you were intentional with that, would you say?
I was intentional to make sure that my lace matched.
Mm.
That's what I was intentional with.
No. Because,
no shade. But no. I was like, I'm not going to go embarrass myself on TV because one thing I do pride myself in is my hair and how I look, like how I present myself. Mm-hmm. So I made sure, like we did with my hairdresser, We went, we shined lights, we did cameras, we was like making sure like everything. With my prepared cream. I didn't do makeup before. Like I barely did makeup. So I had like my makeup artist give me makeup lessons. I took in darker foundation because I'm gonna tan. Like it's just
she thinks ahead.
You have to do that because if you go on holiday, you're gonna think ahead. So I'm going on my long holiday.
Yeah.
So let me prepare. It's not one day and you come back. Like you don't know.
Was there anything in the house that you wish you did or showed more of or I don't know, took a risk or I don't know. Is there anything you wish, if you're going back, you would have done?
No, you know, the thing is, I feel like, as you said, a lot of the stuff don't make it on TV. Look at my grandma. But yeah, and I just think, I was happy with what I did.
Can I ask a question though, actually? So I can't remember the timeline now. I know like after you and Mike broke up, he did like a whole, he had a statement. I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
No, you just met me, but I have to do this. But basically he did a statement and he was basically like, he felt pressure.
Yeah.
I don't know if he was saying he felt pressure to be together or he felt pressure. I don't know what the pressure was.
Yeah, I don't know.
But that was the first time I ever. I wanted to know whether you also felt any kind of pressure.
That was the first time I ever heard pressure in our whole entire relationship. So when I read it, I was like, pressure?
Don't end their pressure in the relationship to like stay together and stuff after you're out because you've got to be together. You're just making money. There must be pressure to stay together. Like even like when you broke up, you must have wanted to break up before you broke up, didn't it?
So I personally didn't feel the pressure, but remember we were in a pandemic, so really and truly people weren't checking for us.
Yeah,
like we were almost even forgot about. But the pressure together, I feel like. With Mike is different. I kind of was always in entertainment because I was like, I used to dance and all of that sort of stuff. Yeah. So a lot of new. It was just like the next level for me. But I feel like Mike was thrown into it.
Yeah.
So it was always kind of like, he always wanted to stay relevant. He always wanted to just kind of grab as much as he could at the time.
Yeah. So whose idea was it to do them stupid dances, the couple dances, stupid stuff?
The couple dance?
Yeah.
We did like one TikTok.
That was too much.
one too many.
Yeah. He's like, one too many.
When I saw that, I was like, these are finished.
I actually enjoyed that. Thank you very much.
It was your idea.
Whose idea? It probably was. It could have been my idea. I'm not going to lie. Probably could have.
But you're a dancer, right?
So that's what you do.
So you said, let me dance with my love.
Not my love.
That's so
interesting. But Mike's quote, what was his quote again? He felt pressure to what? To uphold black love, right?
Yeah, but you know what? Now I'm thinking about it, I can kind of get why he felt pressure. Because basically, I don't know if you guys remember when he first went in and people kind of did a dig or whatever and they found out he was a policeman. And a lot of people kind of had a lot to say about that. Like, black people had a lot to say about that.
He was dead to me after that.
Okay. So I reckon when he came out of the house and read the tweets and stuff.
Yeah.
That might have added to it. I'm not really getting the pressure thing.
The thing is,
to grasp for something.
As a black man, is that the question I asked you? No, it was Eamon I asked. As a black man going on the house and being conscious of, you know, black Twitter and whatever I'm going to say.
Yeah.
I feel like he felt pressure to maybe pick Priscilla because she was black.
Okay,
there's more onus put on the man. I think if Priscilla chose a white guy, I don't think there'll be much.
There wouldn't be.
The backlash wouldn't be as bad, innit? But for a man, I think it's almost put on your shoulders. You're the one who has to make sure you uphold and you create black
love. Because we kind of always assume that black women are going to go for black men anyway.
Right.
So if I see a black girl go for a black guy, or white guy, I would just say, oh, do you know what? None of the guys probably liked her anyway. This is the safe thing she's doing kind of thing. Did you feel like, sorry, I lost my question.
Going back to the Mike thing though, what you said, I feel like he did go through a lot. Like I really did see the pressure
of that
on him. And I feel like he almost had to do like he kind of had to fight for his character again when he came outside of the house.
Yeah.
So I feel like that was more like him just proving like, no, I'm actually a good person. Like I'm okay. I think that's where the pressure could have been. But in terms of our relationship, I feel like it was easy. Yeah.
Was there a particular reason why you looked? I don't know if you looked came out and actually shared why you decided to go separate.
Oh, so I didn't talk.
You didn't speak.
I wasn't a chatty patty.
Yeah, so I wasn't a chatty patty. I love that. She said, talk now.
As I said, I feel like we were just genuinely
different people. Mm. It was a very real relationship. We went through like real, real, real stuff.
And in a pandemic.
And in a pandemic. Yeah. So maybe one day I will talk about it, yeah. that, but it was definitely like a personal thing. And coming out of it on the other side, I kind of realized that I went on a trip to Ghana and I realized I felt happier by myself.
Okay.
Then when I was in that relationship, because sometimes it felt more like we were competing against each other rather than it being a union.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So I just was like, yo, like, what are we doing?
Do you want to know as well? What is the Love Island aftercare like?
Fantastic.
Okay.
Mm. Every week they're texting me, like they provide you therapy for like a year or 2 years or you need it. Okay. Like they don't force you to do it. But the aftercare, A1.
That's really good. That's helpful to know.
Mm-hmm. I'm surprised by that, to be fair.
Did you know what you wanted to do once you left the house? Because obviously you're very okay, go on.
Yeah.
I was like, let me finish the question.
Like, do you know what you wanted to do? Yeah, I always knew what I wanted to do. I mean, I've always been doing the modelling and I was always interested in presenting, because when I was at uni I was doing presenting, I was doing radio, and then I stepped aside from it, just uni and life.
Mm.
And I was like, yeah, now's the perfect time to get back into that. Like, because I went behind the camera as well.
Yeah.
Because I started working for Mr. Easy. So I was just doing all the behind the scenes. And I was like, hold on. When I was working for him, sometimes I was thinking, me too. You know, I'm a star, right?
I can be in front of him.
So yeah. So now I was like, I got the opportunity to just come back out and put my face out there. Yeah.
I love that for you. So does that mean you mentioned working with Mr. Easy and doing all of that stuff? So does that mean moving forward, you just want to do presenting and modeling? You've been doing presenting and modeling full time, right? Mm-hmm. So that's like, you're going. I've seen you be on Rare Talks with Denise.
Yeah.
So is that the kind of direction in terms of like hosting a show? I don't know if it's going to start to step on your future announcements. But.
Oh, no. Yeah. So I think more times down the lines of radio, having my own show, and hopefully TV presenting.
Okay.
In the future.
I love that. So obviously Denise is Ugandan.
Yes.
You're Ugandan.
Yes.
And I saw you lot had a link up. I think you lot forgot to invite me, but it's all right. Don't worry about it.
Denise is actually my cousin.
Yeah. But there's also Daniel Kaluuya was there. Yes. And was it just only people that were, I think Eva as well?
Yeah.
So was it only people that were from Uganda?
Literally just Ugandans that were killing it. It wasn't even supposed to be anything big. It was just supposed to be us. Because it was like, everyone else has their own community. But Ugandans, we barely even know people. Like, people don't know Unknown T's Ugandan and things like that.
Okay.
So it was just like, we all just needed to get together and just be like, oh, yo, you're you, I'm you. How can we connect? How can we just keep like upbuilding? And that's all it was. It was just, let's do
the one pictures look up. Wavy. It looked like a really sick link up.
It was good. Like really it was fun. Shout out, what's it? Isaac from Daily Paper and Daniel Kaluuya. They're the ones that came together.
Put it together.
Oh, the guy behind Daily Paper is Ugandan as well?
He does like all of major marketing, the project and stuff like that. Okay. So yeah.
That's sick.
That's wavy. That's beautiful. Would you ever do something abroad? Like, I know a lot of what you obviously you're Ugandan and you do stuff in the UK and stuff like that, but are you planning to, because it seems like a lot of people are going to LA and doing stuff in LA and stuff. Is that something that's in your future?
Absolutely. I'm actually supposed to be going to Uganda in 2 weeks to be on a youth panel with the African Union and the European Union. Yeah. So I'm all about like going back, and I feel like Africa's where it's at. Afrobeats is already killing it. So I'm just like, why don't I work my way, see what I can do back home, and then come back here.
Now that I've asked the professional questions.
Yes.
So what's your dating life saying? Because you're a beautiful girl, yeah. You're a beautiful girl. And I see a lot of people mention you. Like when you and Hema and Denise put that picture up, it went, you know, black girl magic. It was doing stuff. So what's dating like for you? You don't have to give names unless you want to, because it's CDA. But what's dating life for you after Michael? Why am I saying Michael? Like,
after Love Island,
after like this newfound fame for you, is it harder today? Is it easier today? Be honest. Give us details.
So much harder today.
Really?
Yeah, dating's trash.
Is dating trash because it's trash, or because you were on Love Island and you feel like that's been like a deterrent, so to speak?
I feel like dating was already dead, and then you throw Love Island on top of it, and it's like, I'm sorry. This is a question for you guys, actually. What's wrong? It's true. What is wrong with a woman that's just killing it? Because it seems like a lot of guys, they feel like, oh, I'm independent, or they can't talk to me, or they feel intimidated. Yeah. Like, or is it, do you feel like you just have to move correct, or you scurred?
I think
that's a clip. I would know.
There ain't nothing wrong with a woman like that. I think you're just talking to the wrong men then. I reckon you're talking to men who are intimidated by your success.
Facts.
And you need to find a man that isn't.
So where should she find them? Because yeah, right. They would love to throw that one at you, yeah, no matter what. No,
you're talking to the wrong man.
No, but those men are everywhere, though. I can't say where they're going to be.
Tell me what station.
Yeah.
Get me the Uber.
What station?
No, no, you must get that, like, because obviously you're more popular, you get more attention. Your dating pool is bigger.
Yeah. I don't think that's true.
No. How it works for me is, I think if it is going to be anything, people become my friend first.
Mm. Okay.
They'll be cool with me. And then later down the line, they'll be like, oh, Pris, you know.
Pris. Kinda,
like, then they'll start making their moves. But people don't slide into my DMs. People don't, like, just off the cuff be like, yo. I feel like they tried to ease their way in. Yeah, I feel like they eased their way in.
I think that's
more
out of fear of immediate rejection. Yeah. Okay. But the thing, I don't know. Do you smile? No, I'm joking.
Do I smile?
Approached by, I don't know, athletes, rappers, actors, like guys who necessarily wouldn't be intimidated by a successful woman because they also are successful? Or no?
Athletes, rappers.
Anyone in entertainment?
I mean, obviously, every now and again, someone will drop a, not in my DMs. I feel like in real life, if they see me, they'll be like, oh, right, like you look good kind of thing.
Yeah.
And that, but in passing, but yeah.
You know, is it one of the things, you know, certain women, when they're attached to a certain guy?
Someone has actually said that to me.
I'm shocked.
And the thing is, it was a friend as well. But they did a friend.
But
as I said, they become your friend and then they'll talk to you. They'll be like, oh, do you know what? I thought you were doing perfect. So but then you went and dated my...
I'm blown away.
You know what it is?
I'm blown away.
I have actually heard
there's
that
guys
once.
Not talking to you because if there's a man that will talk to you regardless of if you're in a relationship or not. So why is Mike... Because he's a policeman.
No. The way you delivered it was like, those guys don't rate Mike. That's kind of how you delivered it. And I'm thinking...
I didn't deliver it. You're saying because they don't see
that's not sticking.
By the way, I'm not saying this, Michael.
If that's your type, we're not that's the kind of guy you want, you don't like me.
So you're saying because they don't, is that what you're saying?
That's how man, that's men think like that. If that's your type and that's what you're into, that's the kind of things you want to do in your spare time.
No, but that's unfair because that was on a show.
Even no, but so. She was still with him after the show.
I think your thing's too, like, proper, too prim and proper. You get
don't
me?
Let this guy drag you into the gutter.
No, I'm being dead serious.
Do you know what it is? I have had before that someone
you don't look like a badass. You don't look like you're on smoke. It's all too...
Oh, you mean she looks like she's well-behaved and goes church.
It's all too well put together.
You think so?
Everything's just love. Yeah.
Sis,
yeah. No, but...
Wrong shirt.
I didn't even say.
Sis, what would you do? Because... Are you serious? Are you saying because she comes across... Serious. Obviously, I know he's serious, but...
Yeah.
Like, are you saying because she comes across put together with civilian, law-abiding...
Because then it's a lot of pressure. So if you haven't got yourself together, if you're not prepared to pattern up... She was looking for love. We saw her play that. This is all serious stuff. So if you're not prepared to do that, then it don't even make sense to even go in there. Do you know what I'm trying to say?
Because
the perception and the image is... It's all proper. It's all love. It's all above board. It's not... Some people might be looking for a good time. Just for a good time. You're sexy. Okay. All right, I just want a good time. But then...
Are you looking for a good time?
Are you looking for a good time?
She's looking for something serious.
A serious time.
Something proper.
I don't even think I'm looking for something right now. Mm. Just to put that out there. But let's not say that. Just in case.
Start again.
You've just described men that she doesn't want. Really.
Yeah.
No.
No.
Guys
who just want a good time.
She don't want a good time. She wants a serious time.
Yeah.
No, it's not even serious. You just want a solid time, innit?
That's the best. A solid time.
If it leads to serious,
it's up to you
cool.
to keep him solid the whole time. That's on you. That's ain't on us.
I just can't.
You're just all the hope that's in this room, You're just snatching it up. Do you think you need to travel?
Travel.
Aloni says your man might not be in this country.
It's true, you know.
Do you think you need to travel? What if I said LA?
I might need to.
Because I can't lie. The American guys, from the way I see them on socials, they would love the heck out of you.
You know what? Maybe. I don't know if they'll be proper, though,
because, you know, madness is everywhere. But
it's true.
So
that one's true.
But at least you could have a bit of a solid time.
I'll take a few trips.
But the things that I hear a lot of guys talk very complimentarily, I don't know if that's a word we're going to land, about you. So I'm like, is it maybe it's just a bit of nerves?
Maybe.
Or maybe people don't like to graft. I feel like there is this thing now where people want to put little in and get the most out.
Mm. Mm.
No, that was even me screwing you. Sorry, that was both of you.
We'll see.
That was men in general. We'll so see. Guys, you guys are representatives.
So what, right now there's no potential, no suitors, no one, you know, knocking on your door.
I like to call it a flirt. So I'm flirting right now.
Okay.
I don't think it's anything serious, but I'm flirting.
Flirtatious babes.
Yeah, flirting.
I hear that.
Oh, I love that for you.
Be careful, boy.
So usually we ask like life lessons, do you know what I mean? But I want to ask you Love Island lessons. Like what was the key thing you learned from that experience? And then also just across your life, like what's like something that you feel like you would have to share? If you wrote a book right now, you'd need that advice in that book.
Oh, this
is Love Island lesson first.
A Love Island lesson.
That one's hard.
Okay, they're just doing that for okay, Love Island lesson, I'll just say, just enjoy the moment. Okay. Live in the moment. Mm. And then just analyze everything once you're outside.
Mm.
Mm. Yeah.
You know, I wanted to say quickly, yeah. You see, because you're saying like it's only like 30%, it's running all the time. You see, because you're experienced with the show, yeah. Does it make you look at the contestants differently, if that makes sense? Like, so say like they're showing us something of a character and the public think a certain way of them. Do you look at them a bit differently because you know that stuff might not be shown or whatever? Or do you just take what they give you?
I take what they give me. Sometimes I will give them a bit of leeway, but I do take what they give me because at the end of the day, you know the camera's there. So how you behave is how you're choosing to behave.
Yeah.
So I'm like, if you're coming with Vim, then that's just because you're on smoke. If you're not doing anything, it's...
Because you're dry.
Well, if you're not being seen, sometimes the camera, like a lot of the time, the camera wasn't picking up a lot of people's stories. But what you see on the camera, like what you actually see, I think that's that person.
Okay.
And then in terms of like, you said the Love Island lesson, but in terms of your life, like what's something that you feel like is a piece of information that you benefited from or a piece of advice that you benefited from across your life?
Oh, I wish you guys prepared me for this. I am a very much an experienced girl. So I always say, like with me and money and obviously be smart with money and everything like that. But I feel like life is worth living and it's always worth having experiences. So if you die today, would you be fulfilled with what you've done? Mm. If not, just live every experience to the fullest when it comes.
Sick.
Yeah.
Do you feel like you've lived everything to the fullest?
Oh, yeah. I've enjoyed it.
That's so good.
I always say, me and my best friend, if I died today, I am happy with the life I've lived.
That's really good. Can I ask you another question? What's something we don't know about you? Like, obviously, you've been on Love Island. We've spent time watching you on TV. Like, we've spent time, like, you know what I mean? So what's something that we don't know about you?
Hobbies,
dislikes, just something that isn't obvious.
Something that isn't obvious. Sugar, I am dry.
She just said I've spent my life to the fullest.
Okay.
Well, that's something you've done before that
I've gone bungee jumping.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm a proper thrill seeker.
Yeah.
Like, I love challenges. So I've gone bungee jumping. I've slept on top of like a mountain. I'm just,
For a nap or like overnight?
Overnight. We had to hike up.
I love that.
In the Lake District.
Okay. Sounds like Duke of Edinburgh. Come down.
Yeah.
You like, really be flying this Duke of Edinburgh car. It's so fun.
I hear my every week. I too soon. I didn't do it.
No, I got the way to go. It's really fun. You should try it.
Do you know what? I love cooking programs, but I never cook.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can't cook or never cook.
Never. But won't cook. When I was drunk the other day, 4:30 in the morning, I did make rice and stew.
You proper cooked the stew from scratch.
Yeah.
At 4:30 in the morning, drunk.
Yeah, I was hungry.
That's a bit dangerous to cook drunk, you know.
I did it.
Go on, sis.
Even
stew as well. That's oil and everything. Yeah, you're a thrill seeker.
I did tutorial on Snapchat, so if you want to see, it's there in it. But yeah, no, I can cook. I just don't like to cook.
Yeah. Can I ask? Okay. Was there anyone in the house that you had your eye on besides Mike?
Do you know what it is? Not that I had my eye on, but if I feel like...
What's that henchman's name?
Ched. No, that's who I was actually going to mention. Okay. If I wasn't talking to Mike, yeah. I probably would have got to know Ched.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you regret that things didn't work out? No,
because I wouldn't have been with Chad either.
I was it.
Yeah. I wouldn't see that for you.
Yeah,
I wouldn't.
Yeah.
I was gonna say, obviously you've done the show and whatever, but would you go back on the show? And if you went back, would you have a game plan this time? Like because obviously you went on vibes. Yeah. You just went to enjoy yourself. Mm-hmm. Do you think that you would do it the same way again?
I would do it the same way.
Yeah.
Would I go back onto it? I feel like I don't need to.
Okay, yeah.
But if I was starting from scratch, from the beginning, I'll do the same thing. There's literally nothing
to plan.
There's nothing to plan, apart from your hair and makeup. Yeah. There's nothing to plan.
You know, like sometimes when people come out the house here, that they're all like kind of besties and stuff. And over time, it fizzles out.
Yeah.
Is that because you just live together for so long here that you're kind of used to them and then you, it's kind of like you help each other navigate society when you come out as who you are now. Do you think that's what it is or?
Certain people, I really do think, I always reference it. I call it like a Love Island cult.
Mm. Okay, yeah.
Like I feel like when people come out of Love Island, they're in this like, I'm from Love Island, I'm elite, let's all stick together.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
And I've just never been on it. Cause I said all of them people, no, it's true. All of the people in the house, the producers put us there.
Mm.
You lot are not my G's, you're not my people. Like I don't chill with you. So I've never really been like if I see a few Kaz, I'm like, I rock with Kaz heavy because she's a real one. And there was like another one called like Eva. She's,
I remember Eva.
Yeah, she's cool. But generally, I feel like they, like, don't quote me on this. Like, but personally, I just feel like some of the Love Islanders hang around with each other because they're Love Islanders to just keep the relevance going.
I think we definitely see that, especially when a new season starts. Yeah. And you get like the old guys kind of coming together and like doing a, it's almost like they're on socials, like kind of giving like, oh, big brother, kind of big sister advice. And I'm like, they can't see your tweets.
Can
you close it up?
Yeah, it's a no. I'm really like, as much as I did it and it was great and it gave me a thing, I don't want to be that Love Island girl.
Yeah.
I'm just like, I did Love Island, but I don't want to be that babe.
That babe, yeah.
Mm, we love that. Yeah. Well, we're going to go into a new segment.
I don't want to do it anymore, but
cool. I know you said you're tired of it, but no, it's called fine, Love Island the day after. So let's get ready, guys. You already know the vibes.
Maybe.
We're in Madrid. Where's
is it Marbella?
Marbella, that's
not Madrid. Marbella. They won't have that many blacks in
Love Island the day after.
Island of Fernando.
Oh, remember that? No, yep. Like, you know, like something.
I was booking a holiday. I was trying to go there. I couldn't find it.
You couldn't find the island of Fernando? I think it is a... Is it a... I feel it's a real place. Let's stick to one reality show.
I'm just going to embarrass myself.
It's not.
Can't find Fernando.
Oh, that's upsetting.
I love the fact that you actually tried to go.
No, it's a real place.
Go no likey, no lighty.
Yeah, would you go on it?
Well, take me out.
Yeah.
I would. You go and take me out, but you wouldn't go on Love Island.
Yeah, because it's one day.
It's a whole different.
They're not going to stop me from drinking how much I want to drink.
I can't, like, I would rather go Love Island than go take me out.
I would rather go Love Island, but I feel like, I mean, now that I've seen people conquer it, shout out you.
Yeah.
Like, shout out India. I can see it's a slightly nicer place. But a couple of years ago, you would have been standing there holding people's coats. Like,
no, but even then though, like, true. I would rather hold people's, I can't have you come to my face and turn my light off. I punch you in the throat. Or it's like me and one girl, and then you try to act like you're gonna go to the other girl, but you come back to me.
Do you see when people cut the button with their body? Like, madam, stop.
you're going.
But you know, the guys get it first, though. They come down, they haven't even said anything.
Yeah.
74% of the lights are gone.
I always feel bad for the guys. The guys are getting no lights. Oh, no.
But since we're feeling bad for guys, how do we feel about Akena and India?
I'm glad.
Yeah.
Because this was in bondage.
That was gonna happen. Yeah.
Do you know what he does? He sings her name. When he's in trouble,
when trying to make it up to her,
yeah.
But you know what it is? Yeah, she has had. Honestly, I'll be honest with you. I could not hear that conversation one more time. Last night I was going to be tired of it. She's had that conversation with him over and at least three times a week.
Mm.
So I'm glad that yesterday she was like, do you know what? Yeah.
The stars had their lines.
So she locked it off of him.
She locked it off.
We're just friends. It was done really well. It was done really well in front of Eric Sue. So it was like, this is how you do it.
This is how you do it.
But
I see Dami making moves.
He's making moves. But if I even get to that, so you know when India did the whole, were you crying because, you know, you were caught or were you really sorry, blah, blah. I feel like she and Dami are doing the exact same thing Ekin-Su did. They just haven't lipped yet. Because what it is, the reason why they were upset with Ekin-Su is because she was going behind Davide's back, right? She's doing the exact same thing going behind Ikenna's back. Mm. She and Dami are doing that.
Yeah.
I thought they was upset because they lied. When Thingy lied about it.
But the terrace.
Yeah.
I think they masked it under the terrace thing. Because really, why do you need, was I going to wash plate? Why do you need me? Why do you need to know where I'm at? I think they were just annoyed that she was playing the game the way she was.
And she's very flamboyant with it as well. So something about it can come across as disrespectful if you're in the situation. Do you know what I mean? And she gives people stuff to talk about.
Yeah, like the crawling, obviously no one knows that she crawled, but like
now
the,
when that comes
the
up,
sneaking away for
kids. Moving night, innit?
Yeah, and also when you hear about shit, that's gonna be wavy.
Moving night's gonna be cold. Yeah.
When you hear about stuff in like in bits, it just always makes it worse. So first you said you're at the front door, you're on the terrace. Then we find out that you licked my man. Yeah. Then we're gonna find out that you crawled. It's gonna look mad. Yeah. But you know what? Them two have real chemistry. As
I
in,
don't think so.
Oh, no, she said this today. No. Oh no, he's tired of her because she's a because she brings drama. But I think that's the house, that's the social situation.
No, yeah, I think team, yeah. Mm. I think he's gonna get sick of her. So basically, let me give you context, right? She had a thing with Amber. So so she kind of peeps. Now she and Amber had a moment when she was sitting there with Jay and they were talking to Dami. And they were saying to Dami, like, he and Amber aren't really, it doesn't look like it's going well, basically.
Yeah.
And that's when he was basically saying he's interested in India, blah, 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 blah. And Eki's like, you know what, like, you might have to go and pursue that, blah, blah, that kind of conversation. Then Amber walks in, but then they all go kind of quiet. She tries to do the whole, oh, yeah, and that's why I couldn't sleep and blah, blah. But it's not really landing because it's very awkward, right? Mm. So anyways, they're kind of having that whatever talk. And then she and Amber had a moment.
Jay said to Ekin-Su
after Amber left, by the way.
After Amber left, I think there's a bit of a feeling between you and Amber.
Yeah, a bit of friction between
that
you maybe, guys.
And the things that I think he's tired of, not tired, but he's always with Ekin-Su because no one in the house seems to really like her. And he wants to be part of the house.
Because
secretly he's a producer from the show, in my opinion. But yeah, he wants to be part of the house, right? So so he was like, so then she was like, all right, cool, I'm gonna go talk to Amber. But she was already on smoke. And she did it in the most like high school girly way. She said to Amber, I can't remember how she started it.
She said, I didn't like it. I didn't like the way she started because she started threw Jay on the bus.
Yeah.
She should have just gone and said, oh, I just want to see like things have been a bit off of us.
Yeah, she wasn't direct.
She went and said, I just had the most annoying conversation with Jay. He basically said that you and Paige, he doesn't think you and Paige like me.
Which is true.
And then Amber was like, no, no, no. I wouldn't say we don't like you, but it's just that, you know, the past few days, blah, 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 blah. But Ekin was wasn't trying to hear it.
Yeah.
She was like, oh, like you're pissing me off. It was a bit,
then she said,
a bit dramatic.
And your relationship ain't even that stable anyway. And by this point, all the girls kind of gathered around, innit? And so they were just like, oof, that's a bit. But you need to understand, when you're not the liked person in the argument, you're going to lose the argument anyway. But Ekin-Su makes herself lose the argument, super lose the argument. Do you know what I mean?
I got why she said that because basically Amber was trying to say that the way she was annoyed at the way Ekin did the thing with Jay and Davide. So she's thinking, first of all, your man is trying to be with someone else and you're going to sit there and tell me about my relationship. But again, I don't feel like she landed it properly.
She didn't land it properly.
Then
Gemma got involved.
Did they gang up on her?
Yes. Well, they didn't.
They did. I feel like
they definitely gang up on her, but also because if you don't agree with Ekin-Su, then you're going to just naturally be on the side of Amber.
Side, yeah.
And I feel like what I didn't see is that these guys have already had conversations about how fake they think Ekin-Su is. So Gemma, you know, like when you can tell people have been having conversations. So Gemma says, no, you're just not like Gem. You know how she talks very blatant and direct and stuff, and she just shut down the argument where Amber was kind of like taken aback and Ekin-Su was mad dramatic. Gemma was just like, yeah, we don't think you're real. Then Ekin-Su walks in on Gemma talking about her to all the girls. Yeah. So at this point, it was kind of sad to see because
it was sad to see
because at this point, only the new girl is the one asking how she's doing and shit like that.
Because what it was as well that Gemma said that annoyed me was, so she's having a conversation with Amber, right? But then Gemma comes and she's like, oh, I don't think it's fair. Because all the girls have had conversations. And I think that's the worst thing you could ever tell anyone is that you're having a staff meeting behind my back.
Yeah.
She basically said, all the girls have been talking and they all have issues. So she's basically saying that, I don't think it's nice. It's not nice that you're just directing this at Amber when everyone here.
Yeah.
But what annoys me is that in different scenes, you see them talk about Ekin, yeah. But in that moment, they were quiet. And even Amber said in confession, she was like, I feel like I was the one who took the brunt of that. But these times, you all think the same thing. I personally think, like, I feel like it was giving like mean girls and like secondary school stuff. Yeah. And then when she was in the changing room, when she walked in on them talking about her. And I was a bit shocked because I thought she and Gemma were cool. And that's why I think they're all fake. Because remember when she kissed Jay, Gemma and Paige were the only ones she could trust to tell that she was close enough to tell them. So then when Gemma is then doing the whole, oh, everyone doesn't like you kind of thing. Something that's a bit deep.
But we already been said that Gemma's the head honcho of the girl group. And I do think they all think she's a bit fake. I think the whole world has said they think she's a plant. But she's entertaining as fuck. No, not Gemma, Ekin-Su. But she's like, everyone's just like, yeah, she's a bit dramatic. She's looking for a scene, like all of that stuff. But I don't care because that's what I'm tuning in for. But I guess in the house, they just think she's doing too much.
The British public, I'll get back to that, but the British public don't know good things either.
Or they want to, yeah, they vote. We'll talk about the votes and stuff like that. But then another thing is, just quickly, because this is the last time I'm going to talk about her, Amber, she needs to leave.
She needs to leave the villa.
Well, do you know, she doesn't like Dami. No, she needs to live the whole of Madrid or Barcelona. You know, she needs to leave there.
Leave Spain.
Leave Spain. But in my head, yeah, she is impossible to please. She doesn't like Dami. Everything Dami does is wrong in her eyes.
It's annoying.
She's her facade where before she had no personality is like breaking apart. And now just seeing that she's not nice. Like she's bitchy. Not a nice person. Like she's not.
I can see it.
She's I've heard not, that from other people as well.
Would I know her personally?
No. Just like people that's commenting. Just like, yeah. Like she's just like a, not a nice girl.
Because when she came in, I feel like she had to do the whole like, she had to act like Gemma. Like, I don't really care. But then it's like, there's only so much you can do that because at this point now, you've been there 2 weeks, you're breaking because people are annoying you. And now it's like, I feel like she even rolls her eyes and doesn't even clock
she
it.
She doesn't know she's because
when she was talking to Ekin, Ekin was like, reflex. Don't roll your eyes. I'm having a conversation, but
yeah.
Again, I think her true self of being a meanie is just bursting out. Yeah. She can't control it.
Yeah.
I need to leave the house.
But also, she has nothing to distract her. Like, she doesn't like the person she's with.
Yeah.
No one else is trying to chat to her. So for her, she's like constantly bored and she's just getting really irritable now.
Whose fault is that?
And she's even being mean to like other girls because it's not just Ekin-Su that she does it with. Yeah. She's kind of just, she's done with the whole house. She should do
She's not nice. She's not a nice girl.
But yeah, so
but that's why Dami wants to leave her anyway.
Yeah, Dami's done with her.
Yeah.
Dami's done with her.
Yeah, he's done.
How's Dami going to chat to Ikenna? Ikenna doesn't like India as well, right?
He doesn't.
They had that small conversation. Yeah. Did you notice?
I think they both mutually agree.
Yeah.
Working, right?
Yeah, but yeah.
No, I'm talking about Ikenna and Dami.
Yeah.
When he's because it was just like, I feel like you and India vibe more. They literally said it to me.
Yeah,
other.
He said. But do you know what? Yeah. He said it. Yeah,
it wasn't solid.
No, it wasn't solid, but it was in passing. So it's not. Yeah. It's not going to be a shock. At least
I feel like
it
was.
Yeah, but he was saying that. I think in comparison to how he and India get along,
yeah.
So he was like, "We're not like the way you two are. Like you guys joke and we're like, we don't have that." So really, I'm on your side because I think when he then tells me the news, don't be too shocked.
Listen to blow because if what, he knows already. There's a little bit of a bond there.
Mm,
but like I was asking you earlier, is Dami wrong for making the move on India without really talking to Ikenna properly first?
Absolutely.
But what if
I feel like he is.
What if he doesn't know if he has he wants to see if she's even into
no,
it?
No. Dami knows.
They've already had the question.
He already had the conversation.
Like, no, have you guys seen that every scene Dami is in here with Ikenna?
Yeah.
He or like any scene, like he's got a lot he's thinking about. Like he looks stressed.
this thing is weighing heavy on his heart.
I mean, until he can
they got put together by the public, innit?
Yeah.
They didn't pick each other. No. They've been in there 2 weeks. They've got absolutely no chemistry. Like you're saying, he's spending 24/7 with them. I don't even think he feels like he needs to. It's not like that. It's not even like that between Ikenna and India. Like, you know what I'm trying to say?
It's not.
I think Ikenna wants one of them white things. You just don't know.
Which one?
Yeah. You know what I'm trying to say? Like, so I don't think he needs to talk to him because he's not. You're not even. Like, it's not even like that. You're not even doing nothing.
I think, out of respect, just be like,
the two black boys in there.
Exactly.
And also, they're actually close. Like, they relate on a lot of, like, on the fact that you're black, I'm black, you're my friend kind of thing.
You're tall, I'm tall.
And I think when Ikenna goes to South India, he always goes to Dami to ask. They're each other's brothers, right?
Mm. Yeah.
So I think just say it. I'm not asking your permission.
Yeah, that's okay. Don't ask for permission. No, just tell him. Tell him.
I will let you know that this can't lie to me. Not even say we've had a couple. Don't bring India into. Just say, I can't lie to you. I'm feeling India and I would like to see what happens with it.
That's just it. Say cousin, done. Man. I'm going to chop your thing, man.
But can we talk about, though, how direct Dami was? It's so attractive.
He said, I want you in my beds.
Yeah.
Straight.
Energy.
Room for two. Like,
energy. Was that a good line or was that a bit cringy? Yeah?
It was definitely cringe. That line was cringe.
Yeah.
But I think in the entirety of the deliverance.
Okay. I would like to offer a separate suggestion. This girl has been gagging for attention.
Yeah, that's exactly what I was about to say.
This is not if she was in normal London, then this would be a bit mad, right?
Yeah.
But where she this the only nice thing that Ikenna does to her is sing her name and touch her thigh once every 2 weeks. This is what she needed.
Yeah. She took her back there. When she said it, she was like,
But that's her game though.
That's her thing. She seems unsure. In my opinion, about Dami, unless she's just putting on a little bit of a facade.
Oh, I remember that line. I feel like everything else, I feel like she's a bit short, but she doesn't want to put too much out there. Because basically, when he must have said to her, oh, I feel like we've got a good bond, whatever. And she was like, oh, yeah, but we haven't had the chance to explore it. He said, do you want to explore it? That's the king.
It was very forward.
He was like, do you want to explore it?
Very direct.
Let's go.
I just love a clear...
He's on it.
He's on it. But I feel like with India, to be honest, I don't think she's found her Love Island hero yet. Like, do you know what I mean? Like the person that the moment she sees them, that's a bit of me.
He's a filler. He's a part-time.
He's a filler.
Do you think?
And they might make it work.
It could develop. They could have the sickest bond ever because they have that friendship.
Mm.
But right now, I do think he's a filler. Otherwise, from the beginning, when it wasn't working, and you can see it's not working with Dami and Amber anyway.
But I also
think she's a bit wary of Amber. Like,
that's what
I feel like Amber
say.
Might be a bit, because how she's very blunt, she's a bit feisty in there. So I feel like India might be like, oh, I don't want to step on her toes.
I used to think Amber was a fiery dragon. She ain't, man. Because when Ekin-Su said, don't roll your eyes, she had no, like, without all the girls.
She unrolled them quick.
No, do you know what I mean? I did that differently. I thought she just didn't care.
No.
Because I'd be like, you telling me, don't roll my eyes. Like, I'm...
But can you
she give me that? She gives me that energy. Like, I'll be like...
Nah, she doesn't give me that energy at all. She gives me the energy of I'm going to start something, but I need everyone's to put backing. A battery in my back before I finish it.
Yeah, because she was annoyed that no one backed her.
She was annoyed that no one backed her. If everyone backed her, you would have seen Amber from the beginning to the end. She would have. But when Ekin-Su came with the Ekin-Su energy.
She kind of went back.
Yeah, then Gemma, obviously, was then able to like, wait, hold on. Like, no, we're not going to do this. Do you know what I mean? I don't think Amber... Nah, Amber is just somebody who's frustrated because she's not getting any... vibes, and she kind of predicted she would.
Why I think that Dami and India might work is because I feel like, so you know how Dami is close to Ikenna and India is close to Amber.
Mm.
I feel like they felt something because Dami was even saying they flirt here and there. They'd have a little flirting and whatever.
Mm.
But I think because of who they're friends with, they've never, you had to close it. Like even if you thought by it, they could never really say it out loud.
Mm.
So I really feel like if they get to know each other now, if they let both parties know, I actually think they can flourish in that. I really believe so.
Casamore's gonna fuck up that main house.
What's that whole entire house? Yeah.
That explosive halfway through.
It's gonna cancel. Everyone's gonna have to be sleeping on sofas. No one's gonna be together. My thing with the whole situation with Dami and all of that, I do feel like they're each other's filler. Mm. I think Dami likes, you know, attention, and he does like India, and he's thinking that will turn into something because none of these people would have picked each other at the start.
Mm.
I think even if they had choice, I think that's why they need to take away that public vote thing. I need to see what these people are about.
They did that because
the public vote was good.
I hated it. I think it was good for the black woman because I think that they just didn't want to hear Black Twitter another year. You guys doing threads about the black woman was picked last. They didn't. I don't think they wanted that.
Everyone complained when the black people got put together afterwards. I saw people complaining.
Yeah, but then for them, they're like, we've done what we can. So if they go back now, it's going to be a case of, well, last year we did this and you complained.
Mm.
So what do you really want?
Just send in people that like, don't just send in black people. Send in black people that like black people.
Send in white guys that like black women.
And that, as well, let's add that to the mix.
Wait,
do you know what I mean?
I told you that. That's what they need. They might do that in thing. This is they put bare black people in there. This is going to be the interracial season.
I'm telling you, the squareheads are coming.
Not one light skinned squareheaded person.
Not one. Say Love Island. It's going to be like 4 out of 6.
Yeah.
Just throw them in there.
You know what I think? Dami and India may not work. I think because they're in the house together.
Yeah.
And Dami is the only other person besides the kid that she finds physically attractive. She's drawn to him, innit?
Okay.
But this might be a weird take here, but London girls and guys from outside London, there's not really a marriage there.
I've never thought about that.
You know what I mean?
But he lives too far as well. Like,
he's outside of London lingo and chat.
Ready to move down here.
On the long run, I think he's going to be great on her a little bit.
Yeah, because I don't know. Where's she from?
London.
What part?
I always assume everyone's south, but I don't know.
The only person I know where they're from is Afia. She's gone now.
He's from Manchester
Island.
Or something.
Oh,
Ireland.
So she probably just thinks both of them niggas are weirdos anyway.
That's what I'm saying. like
come Castle and More, they're probably gonna, they might put like a black London youth in there for her.
Yeah.
But he needs to like be it. Like,
I think they'll give her someone.
I don't know if the casting people know how to pick a black. Like, number one, they're not a diamond dozen in terms of applying for the show.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? They're going to have to find them how they found Priscilla. Do you know what I mean? And then I don't know if they're going to find the right one.
Do you know
what
it is? They find them. They don't use them.
ITV messaged me for a show one time.
Yeah, I got a message the other day.
Because
I've got one before.
Because Riley Big Toes was supposed to be in my season.
Really?
And they didn't put him in.
Why not?
Why?
I'm shocked by that.
Yeah, like they didn't put him in. So
I think you would have played it right.
They find people. They just don't use them.
Okay.
People's DBS is checking
about
clean.
Do you know how many people are applying for Love Island?
But did Big Top say yes?
Mm,
that's very important information, sis.
That's it.
You know what I mean?
You can't say they found them. You didn't accept too.
No, they do when they cast. They get bad people. I know a few girls who've told me that they're going on to Love Island,
and then you never saw them.
They never saw them.
I would never tell.
Again, I don't know whether they pulled out or not, but for whatever reason, like I don't know. I know a couple of girls who told me.
Do you know what?
Miles said he was going to go on, right?
Miles.
Yeah, that's what he said he was going to go on.
I thought he was going on or something. But he didn't.
They literally have you on standby. And they're like, it's not until you actually step foot in the house that you're guaranteed. Okay.
Can I say that as well? Do they make you sign something that you can't tell anybody?
So they told us we can't disclose it because that could make us lose our place. In the villa.
So fear of that would make you not say anything.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Do you know what I want to talk about as well, actually, then? I thought, there was an article that says this kissing challenge thing, this mouth-to-mouth...
I thought it was going to happen anymore.
Yeah, they had a whole article saying it's not going to happen because of corona.
Yeah.
So, obviously, I'm thinking about...
We thank God, though. Please.
No, but they did do it yesterday.
They did it yesterday. I mean, they spat water into each other's mouth.
Ew! Yeah, no.
I mean...
It wasn't even water. It was some juice.
It was cocktails. Basically, they were going to... Winners going to win cocktails. They have to fill up their cocktail glass.
Yeah,
and you do mouth-to-mouth to fill it up. And I'm like, ew.
I would hate that.
I had to do that.
I would hate it.
You had to do it?
Yeah, I was like,
you spat in your mouth?
I'm first or second.
Mike,
it wouldn't matter.
It wasn't even Mike. This is my first day. It was Naz.
I
like Naz, man.
Yeah, he's still there.
I work with him. They work with Hyper.
So are you saying what to say?
Is there another game where everyone lines up and you just pass it from person to person to person?
That was ours. We had to make the cocktail. If I'm not going first or second, I'm not doing it.
You spin to Priscilla spin to Margs.
Yeah.
And it goes around like that.
The last girl said the ice was warm. How is ice warm by the time it gets to you?
That's nasty.
I had love, Usman. I can't lie to you.
That's so nasty.
I would watch but then, the sidelines.
Did you? Like, sorry, when you went here, Corona wasn't... We hadn't had Corona then, had we?
No. We didn't know of it yet.
Because I'm thinking, are they... No, because I'm trying to think, would they make them do Corona tests? Because that's wild.
Oh, yeah, you have to. Well, you have to do Corona tests. You have to quarantine everything.
Yeah.
With the games and stuff, do you have a choice?
No.
What if you're not
if you proper start and said, I'm not doing it?
Good question.
No. I tried to not do the talent show.
And they said what?
They was like, nah.
Wasn't that booming?
Wasn't that like your show? Yeah, I didn't want to do it. When I was like, do it. Because we had to, so basically, obviously I had to dance, yeah. That's the only thing I could do. They wanted me to do other thing, but I was like, no, I'm going to do this.
What was the other thing?
No, they wanted me to dance, but they wanted me to do like street dance. And I was like, I'm not doing that.
They said, make it less African.
Yeah. And I was like, no, if I'm dancing, I want to dance to Afrobeats. And they already had Luke T and Shanice practicing from like 2 days ago.
Yeah, Luke T and Shanice.
So I was like, what? You know, tried to set me up and make me look like the dead dancer. Not happening. So we did that. But I just didn't want to do it. I was like, can I present the show? Can I be the host? They're like, nah. Like,
did you know what though? Sorry.
Yeah, go on.
When you asked that question about not having a choice in the games or whatever.
Yeah. I want to practice for music. They played the song for me like 3 times.
The thing is, how far can your stance go? Like if you said, I'm not doing it. Like how far is the back and forth? Like how long does it go for? Or did you just give
him
before
Sharif.
Even got
fast? I mean, after a while.
They'll do a Sharif.
You'll just give up in it because you're like, right, you're the only one.
Okay.
But do you know what though? Can you, so periods, how does that work in there?
Like normal.
You have them. But then what if I can't do a challenge because of that?
What challenge?
They'll give you tampons.
What challenge?
Yeah, like, what challenge? I don't know. Like, say like, the water ones. I don't know. Just anything.
Tampons.
That's crazy. What, bad period pain? Paracetamol.
Yeah. I was literally on my period when I went to my, the safari. That day was long. Couldn't rest. Couldn't do nothing. couldn't even nap. Like, and that was early. We left early, came back late because everybody was going on a date that day. They don't care.
Mad.
Nah, do you lot really there to work?
Yeah,
so
it's
thinking,
shifts.
This
doesn't
sound fun at all.
DLT sounds like...
Okay, quickly, is there people, that like have relationships off camera, if that makes sense? Ooh. So say like there's a couple, but he messes with someone else from another couple.
No, not really, you know.
You're not allowed?
They'll catch it on camera.
Yeah.
Because that will be a highlight for them.
People
are messing around. So they'll just like... But they kind of know that when they want someone to be... with someone else, like they'll make it known. Like even with me, they want my head to turn, so they like will pull me aside and be like, "Are you sure if any guy comes in here, your head's not gonna turn?" And I was like, "No, I'm good." I was like, "Are you sure? Like really?"
Wow.
Yeah. Or if someone was like, I remember, I think this Rebecca girl was like, "Oh, she likes this guy," and I was like, "No, don't pick him. Pick somebody else."
Was it?
Yeah.
Would they ask you what type of guy you like?
Yeah, they always ask us what type of guys we like.
As in, no, when you're in there.
No, not really. Oh, okay. But so they already know. But they already know all of this. Yeah.
So they be hearing people say they like black men or black women, and they just say, okay, you're getting white.
Yeah, basically.
That's interesting.
But then I think a lot of people would lie as well, because we have to send in our preferences weekly or every couple of days.
While you're in the villa?
No, when we weren't in the villa. So like us going in.
Because it changes.
So obviously.
What?
Like for me, example, I knew I was going to go for Mike because he was the only black boy, but I would put like one of the white boys ahead of Mike in the hierarchy just in case it might work him more. They bring you in according to like what's going on.
Okay.
So you might not match someone who's already inside. So they'll be like, oh, we won't use this bombshell, we'll use a different bombshell.
Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah. So I feel like people already know, like they'll go in there and lie. Like I said, I wanted to find love. I didn't.
Mm. So in Love Island, they ended it with voting for the least popular guys and girls. Did the results come out?
No. Yes.
Not the result. We know who's in the bottom four. So
okay,
the public had to vote for the favorite couples.
Okay,
of course,
that was Damien. Weren't it boys and girls?
Yeah, boys and girls.
Sorry, yeah, boys and girls. So with the guys, we've got Andrew, we've got Ikenna,
and Jay.
Yeah. Oh, that's so good for Ikenna. To leave.
In the bottom three.
The bottom three.
Yeah. Oh, so they got the least favorite. No, they got the least most.
Okay, yeah.
So Andrew, I need Andrew to stay there because this sounds so. Actually, no, I'm not saying this.
He's an idiot.
Because I want Andrew to stay in there because I know Tasha's been faking it. Yes. And I just want to see that unravel. So it's kind of bad because it's like,
She's so concerned with random things. Like with Danica. Danica's a dancer. At one point she was like, no one gave me this much attention when I was a dancer. Yeah. This is why she'll never be loyal to Andrew, because she likes to be everyone's favourite. Yeah. Do you know what I mean?
Something's
off there.
So Danica was not in there because she came in. So boys, we've got Andrew, Ikenna, and Jay.
Mm-hmm.
Girls, we have Ekin.
Oh.
So I said the British probably don't like good things. Why would you give us a person that's giving us entertainment? So we've got Ekin, we have Tasha. Tasha needs to expeditiously. And we have
Amber, right?
I'm praying hard.
Oh my god, I thought you weren't gonna include Amber. I just thought take out Amber and Ikenna and we're done.
Yeah, basically.
It makes sense.
They're just doing that for production value. Ekin Su ain't going nowhere.
Ekin Su ain't leaving.
They'll fake those votes.
Yeah. Right. No, they have to.
She can't leave. Yeah.
This is the one time I don't mind them faking votes.
They'll be doing petitions. It's fine.
Because I wanna see Ekin Su's behaviour when Jay gets his head turned. Do you know what's so funny? Yeah,
she's gonna lose it.
Yeah, because I don't think.
But she might need to stop crying though, because I like her being mischievous and that. But then seeing her go through like emotional shit is not fun to watch. Just be mischievous.
No, but do you know what? Her emotional thing is even captured. Because you and I were talking about. He's facing how she's just a professional actress. Like he can't take a serious acting.
Actor.
And when are you an actor? You're a liar.
Liar.
But when I think about it, yeah,
get the fuck out.
Even yesterday, she tried to cry, but there was no tears.
What with the girls?
Yeah, it was like I think she cried like, I have no water to produce, never mind, forget it. So I don't know, but I do think
she have no water to produce.
Yeah, she was like, you know what, I'm just gonna step out. But I do think Jay is, because you know what it is, yeah? There's one thing for you to have personal worries, for you to go to the boys and say that you're involved with a girl who's always starting drama, then he goes and says, I don't want to be involved with someone who's always got drama.
No, it was Jack, and then Jack said,
well, you chose the wrong one, mate.
Yeah.
Jack's always got the one-liners.
But can I say, Jack has had a thing with Jay since day one. Anytime there's a mix-up, Jack, instigating king. Like,
who's the rugby player? Was it him?
Yeah. Is it Jazz or Jack or whatever? Yeah, but anyway, him. So anytime he sees Jay having to eat humble pie, he's loving it, documented.
Frontline.
He said, think about the woman. And let's be real, in that moment, I realised what guys might have to deal with when they're dealing with a girl, even if the relationship is blessed. If the man them aren't feeling her, that was that scene for me. Like, the man them are not feeling Ekin Su.
Can I say that as well? Ekin's going for it. I'm sorry. I'm thinking about it again because, you know, I just remembered.
It's exhausting, isn't it?
Yeah. You know, I just remembered. You know when Gemma was saying, one of the girls basically saying there that he hasn't really gotten to know the girls. Mm. He spends a lot of time with the boys. Why did Ekin switch?
Amber? Yeah. No, but it was Amber though.
It was Amber. Okay.
So it wasn't just a switch based on that. It was a switch based on who was coming.
I don't feel like she said that. I was thinking, the man can get to know people for us to get to know people.
But the thing's that. So do you think Jay's not feeding her?
I think he's feeding her now.
Yeah, it's a bus stop. Yeah.
But I feel like it's gonna
get back on the bus.
It's gonna keep pounding. He's just gonna think, it's gonna drain him.
It is.
And then it's just gonna turn him off.
He said, I've not had to deal with this much drama in my whole life. And the thing is that even though he likes Ekin Su, she's the common denominator.
Yeah.
Do you know what he said as well? I said, I don't want to be with a girl who other girls don't really like. you have friends who hasn't got a strong friendship group. Do you remember that?
But it's like, okay, that's cool in the real world, but like no one there is friends. Like
no, but even weeks. Then, because it's what you said in that, because she's not really getting on with the girls yet, he's always got to, like, that's her entertainment. So he's always going to be away from everybody else.
Yeah,
and the guys don't really like her like that. So she's always going to have to be both of them.
And he's
all
not
the time.
Besotted with her. Like, you guys will create like a siege mentality. If it was someone, if it was like Gemma being like that,
Lucas happy to carry her.
He'll be like, don't worry, it's us against the house. He'll be like, he'll be like, fuck them.
Yeah, he would.
Like, I didn't really like them anyway.
Yeah, he really would.
And that's what she needs. Jay's probably not invested enough.
Lucas, he just wants to have Sunday roast with Michael Owen. Yeah. That's all he wants. That's his end game. He doesn't want to win the 50. He doesn't care about 50 grand. As long as I can secure this girl and I can have a few dinners. And
yeah, he's
I can
definitely
push
cottoned,
my football
he's
career.
Definitely cottoned on that. He knows when his bread's
cottoned
hard.
On. He knows my man's routine.
Like, he's looking at the bigger picture.
He is. Yeah. Danica, is there a point of her being there? Did she play it wrong with Luca?
I'm so embarrassed. Like,
she played it so wrong.
She was not smart.
She played it so
like,
wrong.
Do you actually have sense?
Do you know what it is? The bombshell thing, yeah. You don't have to detonate unnecessarily. Like she literally came in and she could have just gone for somebody who would have actually liked her back. But she went for Luca, who you've been watching is, I don't know if he's still watching, but he's besotted with Gemma's dad.
I think it was necessary for the shake-up. I think
she was going to be sick. She thought it was going to be like, but she picked the wrong one out of the two. She should have gone with the other one.
Jack. Who's the other one?
That's with
Paige.
But yeah. Paige is so likable that destroying Paige's happy home wouldn't have gone down well.
It's fine, but what she was only doing it is for camera time.
Well, what she should have done.
And even so, the results, Luca don't have to like her. The fact that she changed it and everybody's got to start picking different people now, it created what you wanted. You know what I'm trying to say?
I can see there's enough of that. She's not as good.
Davide being there and then my
did you see her yesterday? This is such a small point. But she went to Davide and said, I haven't really shown you that I like you, but I am interested in you as well. And Davide was...
He's like, yeah, you haven't.
He was like, yeah, you haven't shown me that you like me. Well, Davide is over this house. He's done. Everyone's fake to him. He's done. So,
do you know what killed me though? You know how Ikenna and India broke up, yeah?
Mm. Mm.
Remy put up a post and he was like, "Ended friend zoned Ikenna." What was the point of all of that then? I was like, do you know what? That's
yes.
true. Because as soon as she did that to Ikenna, I was like, "You're annoying."
Oh yeah, you're right.
And
Remy,
why did you do that?
Yeah.
And Remy's in a good mood now because H apparently supports him. Oh yeah, he's in a good mood now, which I'm happy about because he had a terrible.
I'm here for Remy, man. I like Remy.
So if Ikenna stays in the house, will you go to the Nico thing or whatever her name is?
Danica knows he's available and she ain't even going to see the shop front. Like, she's not.
Danica don't want him.
She don't want him.
Do you know what it is? Ikenna needs to survive onto Casa More. These girls here are not checking.
He ain't
going to
survive.
He's going.
He's gone. He's boring, man.
Tonight.
He's going.
Predictions. Boring. Who do you think is going tonight? A guy and a girl.
Okay. Amber, please.
Amber, Ikenna.
Amber, please.
I'm saying Amber, Ikenna.
What's the options with the guys again?
Andrew, Ikenna, and Jay.
To be fair, Jay might go, you know. Because Jay is more dry than Ikenna.
I can't lie to you. I think Jay is.
Jay is whatever, isn't it?
I think Jay's...
Ekinsu will leave. She wouldn't leave.
I think he's on his way out.
Yeah, but
that's what I want to know. I want to see the reaction when Jay leaves and if Ekin goes.
The people that... I don't know why he's still there. Davide. I don't know why he's still there.
I wish he was in bottom three. And you know what's mad? He had to say Ekinsu's name. Because he sent texts to different people.
Yeah.
He had to say... He was so happy to say he was like, Ekinsu.
You're a bitch. You know, he's very petty. Yeah, he's very petty. He's forgetting that he never liked her.
Yeah.
He actually moved like somebody who was slightly in love with her and she snaked him. You never liked
her. I don't want Ikenna to leave.
He's probably getting a bit pissed as well, though. No one in the house ain't feeling him, is it?
Yeah.
What did we do?
What would you do if you were in the house?
To survive.
What would you have done in the house, Priscilla, if you were in the house and nobody was feeling you? Like, what would you have been on? How would you conduct... How would you do it?
I don't like shame. I really don't.
That's a word.
I don't like embarrassment.
Yeah, that's a word.
Yeah, no, if no one ain't feeling me, I'm going to try a friendship couple this out until I find
someone. A friendship couple?
Yeah. We got a roll. I got to make you my bestie, so I know that you're going to save me until the next round.
Sense. And that's why I rated Amber. Because when no one likes Amber, she and Ovi just carried on their friendship. And then he saved her, she saved him. They kept doing that until they found people.
So that's what even Amber should do should have done with Dami. They should have just become friends. Like, it's not working. Let's become friends. Let's roll this out.
Yeah.
She is such bad vibes. But we'll keep you guys up to date with what happens tomorrow. Thank you so much, Priscilla.
Thank you for having me.
You're a great guest.
Honestly, you really
good
are.
Vibes, honest.
Thanks.
Skin's popping.
You know.
Come on.
I love it.
Energy.
Love it.
Let's head into the outro.
So silly.
Yo,
Yo, beautiful people. So can we just give a round of applause to Priscilla for coming through? There we go.
I loved that.
And shout out to all the hosts. As you know, we're hosting by the very best. So shout out to every single one of you guys for bringing it. And yeah, man, make sure, and everyone that actually tuned in as well, we appreciate you. Make sure you comment, follow all our social media, share our videos. Remember, share with two friends and five enemies. And remember, if you want to send in a voice note or text message for our advice or any of our daily segments, send it into 075-6484-1073. That's 075-6484-1073. And remember, guys, very, very soon, you'll be able to watch us live every day. And we'll be giving you those details very, very soon. But guys, if you want to inquire about the show or wish to feature on the show, email the team at thedayafter@thenewblack.com. Black has an X. Have a wonderful Tuesday.
Yes.